It's murder on the dance floor. You better not kill the groom, DJ. Gonna burn this goddamn house right down.
4, 3, 2, 1.
Oh, I know, I know, I know, I know, I know, I know, I know about your kind. And so and so and so and so and so and so and so, I'll have to.
Better run. You know who isn't sad? Me. Psycho Cannoli. Shout outs to the beautiful T coming in here. T had a great comment that made me chuckle while the intro was playing, because it's such a genuine statement and an honest assessment. Does this sum up the Cannoli Mafia streams? Hey, Joey, what are you getting into tonight? Which emotion? Am I going to laugh, cry, yell angrily, or sigh? Sometimes, T, it's all the above. On Tuesdays, we wear toxicity within reason. Now, of course, we did I thought it was a fantastic Shishi LaRue tell-all interview. I'm a big fan of Shishi, guys. And I hope you guys enjoyed the stream as well. Murder on the dance floor. Good to see Ashcon. I'm here for a good time. Not a long time. Love you, long time. But yes, happy Toxic Tuesday. The link has been dropped. Let it rip. Shishi LaRue, Cuckoo Ka-Choo, you bitch, you Alex Chu. There you go. Abso-fucking-lutely. I'm in a glass case of emotion. Shoemaker, why don't you hop on here? Blow off some steam. What are you doing? Oh, hell yeah, CK. I did bring the laptop back, of course. Not the laptop, I had the keyboard back, Shoemaker. I knew you were missing it. I read your comment. Was it yesterday? I read your comment yesterday. Yeah, big fan of Shishi, Callie. I said normalize wearing diapers. Whatever. Just realized something. I was watching Juan. No disrespect to Juan. And as soon as I jumped over here, Joey's voice was just so soothing. Damn, Scouse. That's the nicest thing you've said all month. There's my boy. How you doing, Montrese? What's up, brother?
Hey, man. What's up, bro?
You know, I just wrapped up the Shishi LaRue. Did you enjoy it?
Man.
Parts of it, at least.
Parts of it, yeah. I had to dip out for a minute.
That's okay. Yeah, it got a little wild, huh?
Uh-oh. But I like him, though, man. He's cool, man.
Kay, is that your real hair? So what is this? You're muted, Kay.
It's a wig, and then here's a clown for you.
Okay, now who is this clown? It's a Toxic Tuesday.
Montrese, who's the clown?
Who's the clown of the week, Montrese? We're going to start a new segment called, hey, there he is. Congrats, Joe A. You better be over there watching Joe A.
Congratulations.
Okay, well, look, there's one clown. He's the clown every day. But to me, the clown of the week is definitely Whiskey Bitch. Definitely.
I would say so. Yeah. So
perfect. This is Whiskey Reaper. He's a little bit. He likes to stick his thumb in his ass, but that's his own business.
Right. Did anyone have time to watch the Comedy Central roast of Whiskey Reaper on Mel's stream? Did anyone watch? Yeah, it's kind of hard to... Why could you even give a fuck? Why watch a guy you don't care about?
I had to watch it, man.
You did watch it.
My okay. Eyes, bro.
What did you think? You watched it in its entirety.
Sure.
Mel's channel? Can we link Mel's channel? Let me see if I can link it. Give me a second, guys. Now, her old channel got deleted, unfortunately. So now we have her new channel. Murder on a Dance Floor. All right, here it is. Ladies and gentlemen, go over there to the beautiful Mommy Mel's channel and subscribe. You ever make homemade cannolis? Yeah. Around Christmas time. We have a machine, a maker, Mama Cannoli. My aunt, oh my God, we used to do Zeppelis. And I forget what those are called, the flat cook. I can't believe I'm not remembering. They're like flat cookies with the beautiful design with the powdered sugar. Someone help me. They're like an Italian holiday cookie. Very good.
That's what I call them. Just Italian holiday
cookies. Italian holiday cookies. The Whiskey Creeper. So the clown of the week. You're welcome, Ashcon. Montree says it's Whiskey Creeper. But not a biscotti. They're like big and flat, and they almost look like sometimes they have like a, or maybe nitro, not the prosciutto. You know what I'm talking about? Anyways, fuck it. But those are my favorite. My Aunt Josie used to send them to me. Pazelles, for Christ's sake. A Pazelle. There it is. I fucking love a Pazelle. It looks like Sage kind of sat on it and then got up. You're like, what the fuck did you do to my cookie? Very good. Then waffles. The Pazelle. Yeah, a little Pazelle. Who's Nitro Border 17? Welcome. Gabagool. Good to see you. That's how we say hello in the mafia. We go Gabagool. Now, someone messaged me and said, Joey, where's the part? And I on Instagram, and I didn't know what they were. I go, what part? What are you talking about? And they gave context. They go, where's the part about your father? And I said, God damn it. So I went back, Montrees, to that part on Mel's stream.
He deleted his comment.
And the pussy deleted it like the bitch he is. I can't say I'm surprised. That is bitch tit energy. But luckily, the goofy son of a bitch, Mel screen like highlighted it. Mm-hmm. Big rip to Holly. So I was able to get a screenshot. Of him talking said shit.
Oh yeah.
If you have to delete your comments, immediately you're bitch made, Montrees.
Already. Y'all gotta say something real quick.
Go ahead. So the clown of the week, Montrees.
Well, the clown, everybody know who that is now. But I'm really feeling the 80s theme, bro. Like you got the glasses on.
Yeah, I wanted to do a little theme. Yeah. Coming into the new month.
Some city shit.
You fuck with it?
Man, listen. See, everybody was San Andreas fan.
I was good a Vice game. City fan. I love San Andreas. Great soundtrack.
Exactly. Bro, yeah, Vice City was my favorite. For me.
It was Scarface.
I love it. Yeah, exactly. You know what I'm saying? Listen, they got me when they had a club on there. I was sold, bro.
Yeah, you went to nightclub and then you start unloading on motherfuckers. Who did it? Hey, well, welcome, Nitro Border. What's up, my guy? This is crazy. The Paris Hilton cologne review. Yeah, that's a great summer scent. $20, little melon action. Speaking of melons, right? Melons, Kishy K. How do you feel about them? You like melons?
It's quite interesting.
This is what you wanted, Kishy K.
Yeah, I don't think it's on a through, but it's all good.
You don't think it's what?
I'm just happy to be included with everyone.
But look at the beautiful polka dot bikini you're wearing. You don't like it? I thought you wanted it. I didn't put you in because I wasn't sure if you were okay with it, and now I got to take. You don't like it?
Oh no, it's good. It's funny. Mm.
Okay, well, if you don't like it, I can remove it.
Yeah.
There was a few people I didn't add because I just wasn't sure if they'd be okay with it, you know?
Ooh.
But
I'm okay with it.
Okay, it is. I did give you a polka dot bikini out of respect. Teeny weeny. Right, you look good, Kay. And I felt like these were accurate. It is. It does sound like she's a little disappointed. I think she's too nice to say. I don't know, I could be wrong.
It's just the belly button.
I can't control the belly button.
I just haven't seen a belly button on my belly in years. So.
Oh. I don't think anyone's looking at the whole belly button, to be honest, if I had to say so myself. Between you and me. The bottom looks like a doll. Nothing there. Sage is the hottest of them. Speaking of hot, Yara's here. It's really nostalgic. One of the first for me 15 years ago. Listen, when you're a teenager and, you know, money is hard to come by, you know, a $20 bottle of Paris Hilton is like magic juice because women went crazy for that fruitiness, the melon note in there.
That was a good
it's
time.
Still it is, man. It's still masculine while being appealing to the women without smelling like a feminine Summer's Eve douche, if you will.
Shout out to the douche.
Shout out to the douche. Great, you know, classic. But I love Paris Hilton. I think I have two bottles, 200 mls, just in case I got to fuck around. Yeah, that's actually not AI, Duncan. Vice City, the memories. Cruising around Luther Vandross, never too much. There he is. Oh, shit.
Hey, what's up?
I am a bit fruity at times. So we're doing Toxic Tuesday, and I'm starting a new segment called Clown of the Week, Lou. Montrese named the Clown of the Week, and it looks like you and him have the same idea.
Mm-hmm.
Is that his actual mustache?
Yep.
He looks like Gomez Adams. Like Uncle, Uncle Fester fucked Gomez Adams.
What up, Lou?
Are you sure? Is that AI or is that for real?
It's for real.
That's a goofy looking son of a bitch. You know, I never actually, you can almost see him because of the glasses. I forget what that's called.
Oh, shit.
You can actually see his eyes. What a silly fuck. Okay. And this is the guy?
Oh, shit. Hang on.
I never knew that.
Yeah.
Look at his little teeth.
Yeah.
Damn. Anyways, that's crazy.
Funny.
Juju could show her bazongas, her bongos more often. Marcus Mandel. Every once in a while, you know, Juju will give a little cleavage action. I always tell her, I said, honey, you got just a fantastic pair of breasts. Julissa's, and of course, you know, they're very... little melon action, Maddie. Good to see Maddie. Maddie OG. He's not the clown of the week. He's clown of the month. I don't even know if it's clown of the month. Maybe the biggest clown of all time.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
He's even worse than Kevin.
Worse than Cuddles. Cuddles would as much shit.
Worse than Kevin.
Kevin would never say something like that. Because one thing that I know is when it came to family, those close to him, father figure, mother figure, especially culture wise, you respect. It's a lot of love. What Whiskey Reaper said was fatherless activities. Like he doesn't understand what it's like. Therefore, he's too immature and too ignorant or self like to understand what it feels like. Like that's an irredeemable thing to say to someone, to anybody. You say something like that, you cross that line, you don't come back from it. You any respect that anyone has for you, if it even existed to begin with, is eliminated. You can and listen, when he said it, in my mind I go, damn, I've beaten this man mentally. And that's like he took the easy way out. Does that make sense? Like
it's kind of like slow and steady wins the race, and you like kept your cool, and you didn't have to lower yourself to that level to win. So.
I was disappointed that he would go to that level. Did it bother me? No. But it opened my eyes.
Well, you know, I mean, look. How old is Whiskey? What, 61 or some shit?
And well, you would have thought that he was an old man the way he, like, I don't know. He tries to, like, take, he or was it Joe Anthony? He would try to take shots of, like, about an age thing.
I mean, but look.
It's so weird to me.
He's supposed to be an adult, right? So.
Allegedly.
Yeah, he's supposed to be. So, when you throw the, your father is dead or your mom is dead. Yeah, that it just shows me how fucking immature you are at your age.
Correct. But Skells, it's true. You've admitted defeat psychologically that you've lost. And poor Mel is having drinks, trying to cut loose. It's a nice, relaxing Saturday afternoon. And here you have this clown trying to hijack and make a spectacle. And after he said that, Mel kind of shut down. It really fucked her up. She didn't know what to say. She was uncomfortable. He put her in such an uncomfortable position. I don't think I've ever seen Melissa act that way. And I was talking to her backstage. It was kind of sad. But one thing that was clear to all of us was just the fact that what he did was so uncalled for and unacceptable.
He's 35, by the way.
Is he 35?
Yeah.
Yeah, so there you go. But in it, mentally, he's like 12 or 13, I think. Maybe it's like a stunted psychological thing. And that's how I said, I go, you have this obsession with young people and kids and maturity aside, that's a really shitty thing to say about someone. We all like to bust balls. And listen, I'm all for trolling and fucking around. I am. But I think when people say something on that level, they're trying to hurt the individual. They know that nothing that they've done is getting a reaction. So they go, how can I hurt you? That's a tough 35 years old. You can't be 50 and dress like you're 15. Right. I did think he was in his early to mid 40s, not fucking
did
around.
You?
Oh, I genuinely that, did.
I'll be honest. Oh, okay. Fair dues.
Yeah. But, you know, I never had an issue with the guy. He would talk out of his ass. It was good fodder. The mafia let him know how it was. But then at some point, you know, I think once again, there's got to be an obsession or some mental instability involved for him to. It sounds like boomer energy. That fucker's still alive. But I do have the screenshot of the message that he cowardly deleted, which is really funny. Why delete it? It's already out there. Everyone's seen it. It's so odd. What are you hiding for? Right? Am I the only one that's...
Joe, it's to save his blooming YouTube channel that's like...
Oh, yeah. Very successful streams. Big audience, a lot of people, big reputation.
He's going to be canceled, Joe, if they find out. They're going to be making videos about this shit.
They're going to be making videos about this kind of shit. Sounds like Boomhauer. But so I guess you could say, yeah, the cowardly deleter, if you will. And then Julian came in. So, all right, clown of the week. Ladies and gentlemen, here he is. Starting the new year off on a high note, an irrelevant clown of the week, though not somebody that's, you know, fun or provides entertainment. It's not, you know, like the Dan stuff was fun, Lou. You know, we had a good time.
I think my clown character was way better too when I had the clown makeup.
Right. he did well. Yeah, he said he wanted to take me under his wing and do an alliance, and I'm like, oh, this guy wants to link up. I'm down. I didn't know him at the time. I was okay with it. And I remember going on his stream. It was all right. It was okay. He had some people at the time, I think, that were watch related. So there was that. But like him as a host, it wasn't anything to write home about, right? There was no entertainment. There was no draw. There was no charisma, I guess. Like there was a character, but it just didn't translate enough to be entertaining. You had to let other people make it entertaining. And I think that's a big problem in the streams, Lou, is that like sometimes not everyone's meant to be the host.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, definitely.
And that's okay. It's not a sign of disrespect. It's not a flex. Yeah. Some people just shouldn't be host. They shouldn't be hosting the stream. Maybe they're better on the panel. Maybe they're better in a chat. Maybe they deserve to be lurkers.
Everyone plays their part in a different way. Like not everyone's what do they call it? Life right. and soul of the party or whatever. Some people are like the guy you talk to after the party.
Sometimes you need people that bring cigars, that bring alcohol, you know, because then they feel like you need them because they supply things to get you to like them. That's crazy, Skells. That's fucking insane to think about. But, you know, God bless him. I tried a whole bunch of whiskey. Thanks for nothing. Sticking to Tito's Texas Vodka Classic. There you go. So the clown of the week, John. New tradition on Tuesdays. Who is the clown of the week? The Mafia. Lou Montrese. Drop a 69 if the Creeper is the clown of the week for Toxic Tuesday. Kyler says he has a face made for radio. God bless the radio.
I can see clown of the week being a very controversial section, like going forward. I mean, it's definitely toxic.
It's a Toxic Tuesday tradition. Do you think a better term? Excellent. It's inspired by John, of course.
No, because if someone gets it, then they deserve it. I'm not saying that. I'm just saying some people like may get butthurt about it, but we'll see what happens.
That's what I love tea, by the way. I agree. For instance, I don't have the personality to keep people interested. However, my husband has the personality, so he joins me. You got to know your lane and stay in it. Listen, T, I think for some, it's the, you know, don't go chasing waterfalls, right? The ass clown of the week. Sometimes you just got to stick to the rivers.
You should edit his face with, like, clown makeup on it.
Yeah, I don't think I want to look at that for too long. It does make me a bit uncomfortable.
The amount of editing I've done today, I've done loads of pictures in some group chat, I've done thumbnails, and I've done this.
You've had a busy day, huh?
Yeah.
You've been doing big things, Lou. I like this. I like this energy.
People are going to see it. Yeah.
So we're checking 69s for Clown of the Week. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Oh, wait. 7, 8, 9. 10. All right. 40 people watching. We need more. We need more. I wouldn't even give him that satisfaction, Skells. Could you imagine? The guy doesn't need makeup to look like a clown. His actions do that for him.
And he has the most annoying voice ever.
I don't believe that's real. I don't believe it. No one can sound like Christopher Walken mid-stroke unless
you're
Christopher Walken mid-stroke. Yeah, but there you go. Kishy K. I'm just seeing the screen. Why y'all doing him like that? K actually made a I Heart Whiskey Dow. Here it is. It's going to go in the Cannoli Mafia Museum. Kind of like how in The Conjuring you have the Annabelle doll. This is our clown doll that we keep in the Mafia Museum of Fun. What does it smell like?
I don't know. Okay, so I got to tell you. I got 6 boxes of big giant Home Depot boxes of free vintage dolls, and me and my friend went and picked it up, and then today I went and I bought a booth at an antique store. So February 1st I'm gonna be in an antique store with That's my beautiful. Home.
I love it, Kishy K.
Yeah.
A friend from Mr. Calvin. Congrats.
Yeah.
So we have the screenshot right here, ladies and gentlemen. Joey,
when you say that, ladies and gentlemen, the saying about it makes me laugh.
You like that? Joey, we understand you grew up with no father. We all try to help. So one thing that I learned is that you have someone that tries to pretend like they know what they're talking about when it comes to anything. But there's some people that are so bad at bullshitting and give such bad advice that when they do attempt to come off intelligent, they have misinformation. And here's another example. To grow up without a father, you know, and I even said it to him, I think my father passed away when I was 20. So I definitely grew up with a father. Did he grow up with any father is the real question. Because that's a fatherless energy right there.
He did. You know, Whiskey Reaper, he grew up with a father, man. His name was Joker from Batman. That's what
okay.
he did.
Okay, shout out. It's the Joker enigma, if you will. I'm sorry. Whiskey Reaper is under clown suspicion. As you can see, Lou has come in. He has come in here. It's a great. This would be a great T-shirt, by the way. What do you think this?
Yeah,
stands
I was gonna
for?
Say I'm repping the new merch.
Yeah, this know? New Cannoli Mafia merch. He grew up listening to a radio host. Maybe, yeah. So, right. Shout out to taking shots though at dead family members. That's crazy. He also disrespected the wife, saying she was slobbing on his meat, which, you know.
Never.
Right, right. But
see, Whiskey's the type of guy that waits around for those ads to pop up on commercials so he can scan it with his phone so he can buy one of them things that'll jerk you off. He's one of them.
Sure. Well, that's the thing. When you can't talk shit about someone. Because the first thing I said, I'm like, dog, you don't even have a woman. Women won't. I go, maybe you don't even have a girlfriend. I have a wife. I have a fucking beautiful wife at that.
You got a pocket pussy problem.
Right. I'm like, you have to pay women to be around you. And then, and I said, maybe you should get a boyfriend. You know, maybe go the other route. Not that there's anything wrong with being gay, but if you realize that women don't pay attention to you, no matter how hard you try, maybe the men... yeah, wives are off limits, dead relatives, kids, but that's rock bottom. And it was a cry for attention and desperation. And I kind of just sat there smiling. Cause in the back of my mind, it was checkmate at that point. The second that comment dropped, I already won. I already beat the game. Hemorrhoid eyes. That's crazy.
He probably doesn't clean his butt, so he can't be gay.
Well, you think with all the time he spends in the shower crying after Julian put him in a fucking emotional headlock, it's surprising. It's surprising. You think you'd wash your ass while you're in there. But some people drink in the shower. You know, it's that some people like to have to get drunk in the shower. Allegedly, of course. So, clown of the week.
Clown of the week. Go get the new merch.
Get the new merch dropping soon. Kishy K. I wanted to swing back by here and say goodnight. Goodnight, Uncle Coots. I was over at Juan's watching RXL roast everybody in Fraycom. I'm surprised Juan has that. I know Juan always talks about not messing with the drama. So I'm shocked that he's doing drama on a Tuesday. He always says he stays away from it. Now I feel like I'm missing something good. Like I want to go over there. It's important to wash them good. Yeah, if you're gonna wash them, Mark, the shower's probably the best time. Yeah, too much respect to give this schmuck. It's true. Is clown too much? Yeah, because clowns sometimes make you laugh. I don't think he's ever made anyone laugh. But some clowns do creep you out. Of course, going back to Pennywise, right? John Wayne Gacy. I'll be honest. When Cuddles would dress up in the face paint, it was a bit unsettling. I'll never forget the original Cuddles the Clown. Whiskey Dick is in Juan's chat room right now. Is he? Still trying to find a home. God bless him. Oh, my God. Who is this?
Another clown.
Okay. Well, yeah, John always called Cuddles the Clown. It kind of became a rite of passage. So it's only out of respect that we bozo, if you will, full-time bozo. And that's all the toxicity I have that I can think of, ladies and gentlemen. You dropped your pocket. Yeah, there you go. How you doing, Dan? How's life treating you? You doing all right? Good to see you, bud. But so Dan came in. I was cracking. You guys don't know, but he's seen the Stinkwell videos. Yeah, I'm talking to you. He's seen them. We call that marketing. That's marketing. It was the perfect marketing ploy. Savage, he says. Savage.
What he found his way here through the chess videos.
No, this is family. This guy's family, like family, and he somehow stumbled across it, and he was asking about it. I think he's seen it for the first time, and that's clever marketing. You know, completely sold out. By the way, Triple X completely sold out, ladies and gentlemen. Shout outs to Blood. Shout outs to the Bloods, Montrese, out of respect. There you go. Super sweaty. He said that shit was hilarious. You got to leave him wanting more. So, KK, you don't strike me as someone that has a lot of toxicity.
Nah, I like to just be chill.
Someone go back over to Juan's chat and tell Reaper congratulations on being Clown of the Week. Some people are saying Clown of the Month.
Clown of the Year, fuck
yeah. That comment was Clown of the Year, because I have a feeling that the next Clown of the Week isn't going to be on that level of severity. What should qualify as Clown of the Week? What gets you into that? Should we vote on it? I feel like I shouldn't be the only one, you know, settling on who's the Clown of the Week. Should we take a weekly poll on Tuesdays for Clown of the Week? What are you thinking?
The only thing is, if you do a poll, then you've got to have a few options on it.
Well, yeah, that's the thing. Unless someone really fucks up, and then they're every option, right? Kind of like the 24 Lifetime Clown Hall of Fame. Oh, we'll get them out into the world. Yeah, remember an ice cream truck used to... Oh, yeah, the Bozo the Clown Cup ice cream. The German guy was kind of a clown. So, I was talking about this, and it didn't come to me until everything was already said and done. A year ago was his last appearance, Lou. It's been a fucking year, right? And what's crazy is I remember a year ago him saying how he would shave his head if a woman came on smoking a cigarette. There's such a fetish. I wonder every time he shaves his head, because his hair was relatively short as it is.
Who is this guy?
We had a German guy last Friday that we've had on here maybe two or three times over the years. And he said, you get two women on here to smoke cigarettes and I'll shave my head bald. What is Plank of the Week, Lou?
I like on the UK news channels when they pick Plank of the Week. I don't know.
There you go. Shout out to Cadman. But it's a classic movie, broad fetish. We're gonna do Clown of the Week. What qualifies as a clown?
Your acting.
So looking like this is a clown activity.
I think if you become like a main topic of conversation, like if you've riled loads of people,
right? Like if people give you the privilege of their time and attention.
I mean, it's one of those things where you just know it's going to be spoken about on the next Toxic Tuesday. That's how you're going to know. You just know.
This is a genuine question. Aside from cuddles, genuine question, what was the most controversial, the biggest, the captivating, what's another good word? Like, what was the biggest thing to happen here in this community? We do need to set these parameters. But you know it when you see it. Polarizing figures, I guess. Other than cuddles, who would you say is in the Hall of Fame? Bumpkinhead, if you will. How you doing, Stoney?
So Stoney.
So we know that there was the cuddles fiasco. What is the closest thing? Velma after cuddles?
I was gonna say
she Velma. She was up there, but I don't know if she was on that level.
No.
Maybe a top 10, put her in like 8th.
I mean, where does Hippie place on the list?
For mafia purposes? Wow, Hippie was such a bipolar flip of the switch. We all were kind of in love with Hippie when those first 30 minutes. And when it was good, it was great.
She was downing beers. I remember that.
She was maybe drinking beer and energy.
Maybe it wasn't like beer.
It was like C4.
Oh, that's a shout. My two cents coming on here and starting that whole. Because although there were
few people, that's a good one.
He basically caused it because until he did that, no one had a problem with each other.
Right. Like, and you know what's so funny?
Underrated villain.
You know what's funny about that, Lou? I didn't know who he was at that time. I didn't know who Brian was, who my two cents was. And I had him on here, and I also wasn't familiar enough with Margie from my recollection. And it kind of just unraveled before our eyes, put me in a bit of a situation and a predicament. But I could tell there was like mental health things going on, and I had to be very gentle with my approach. But the damage was already done based off of the words that he was presenting us with.
I really wish he just never did it, because I'm the first one to know about it, because he told me about it privately days before this.
Wow.
Privately. So I already knew about it. And then when I found out that he'd said it publicly, I was really upset about it. And I even told him, I was like, I don't really like that you did it. And look what he caused.
Yeah, he did cause a bit of a shit storm, if you will. Hippie was a supernova. Peter South, not to be confused with Peter North. Clean boning Margie, and then Margie treated him. Okay, so the 22 days, multiple fucks. It's been a fucking year. If I had to, second place after Cuddles.
Yeah, totally.
No doubt in my fucking mind.
I mean, that won an award, didn't it?
I still say it's been a fucking year. And it's no longer a joke. It's become a lifestyle. Dude, I swear to God.
Merch as well.
Yeah, I think we could do that. You know, I think we'd do it. Oh, shit, my fucking nose piece fell out of my pit vipers. There it is. It's really hard to find, Dunk. So, yeah, it's been a fucking year. Oh, God. Just chilling, 2024. Skells says I went over there and congratulated him. I'm sure he's watching. That's because he's over here now, Skells. Come on.
The thing is Reaper not on One's Dead to Me list?
Oh, that's a good question.
That's the first thing I thought.
I couldn't see Juan giving him the time of day.
Thought he was.
Yeah, because Juan would know about what's happened and all that.
Have we had Juan's first candidate for the Dead to Me list for 2024? Because we're 1 month into the new year.
You should tell him about what happened.
You know what? Yeah, I don't think Juan would be too happy if he found out. You know, I didn't want to go on Saturday and make a spectacle of the clown, you know. I let it marinate, and then I said, you know what? If people see it and bring it up, I'll talk about it and let others know. Like I mentioned last night, if you want to go over there and watch it in its entirety, unfortunately, the version you're going to watch is the bitch-made edited version that was... specific comments were deleted. Key comments were deleted over there. So I don't know. He's his own shit show, Shoemaker. So. But you can still watch me smoke his ass for like, I don't know, Lou. Was it an hour and a half? It was a long time.
Yes, I know that.
It was just like it was a roast stream. It was the Cannoli Mafia roast of Whiskey Reaper. I'd like to bring the roast.
You get to hear Julian on the phone as well.
Yeah, I called Julian. He did put Julian in timeout, which is crazy.
That's bitch mode too, isn't it?
Yeah, at least he didn't block him. I gave him credit. But just the fact that he silenced him was pussy. Zoo vs. Aquarium also was up there. It was funny. It was definitely funny. I don't think it was prolific enough to like set a catalyst. In a way, you know, the zoo was a funny comment. The Zoo and Aquarium, I always liked. And if I'm correct, was it Whiskey that called it a sewer, or was it Dan? I can't remember.
Oh, it wouldn't have been Whiskey Reaper. I think it was Dan, probably.
It was Dan.
Wow.
Juan is the biggest hypocrite crybaby in Fragcoms. Says he doesn't like drama, but talks shit. I love when you get a schlonghammer take out of the blue. Shows up with a paragraph.
Right, everybody.
He says he doesn't like drama, but talks shit about everyone. He poops in his diaper daily. Very on brand for the last stream I did. I am proud to be on his Dead to Me list.
Alrighty then.
You know, I'd like to get Sticks on here sometime. Because he can come on here now. He can come on here now. And he knows what I'm talking about. Because, you know, I could maybe count on one hand the Schlonghammer appearance. He doesn't have to turn his camera on or anything, but he's done it once. I read somewhere that Nacho was really good. Did I miss something? Yeah. Yeah. Every Tuesday we're going to do Clown of the Week, George. And of course, the Mafia has spoken. Clown of the Week, the Whiskey Creeper for the Dead Dad Fodder, if you will. And of course, disrespecting of the wife, which we know there's a zero tolerance. Right? You know.
Of course.
Push comes to shove. You want to fuck around and find out. That's probably the way to go. Is that Nacho cologne from the Polo Player Nacho? Yes. No, it's from the... I swear that's a joke. What the fuck is this? Joey, you're the biggest clown.
Don't you have Halloween clown masks?
I have a Pennywise mask somewhere. I have the Elephant Man. I have Leatherface.
I remember you got some masks.
Yeah, I got the pretty here. Give me a second. I got Pretty Lady, which is my favorite. Let me play some music while I get ready.
He's got to get beautiful for all.
I do have to get beautiful.
Shouts to Joel, who's also into this.
You're gonna like this one. Anyways, I started blasting, right? Biggest clowns are guys who think there's such thing as a panty dropper. It's fucking insane. This is not my beautiful wife. That was, of course, Leatherface Montrese, Texas Chainsaw Massacre.
There you
go. Shout out to Leatherface.
Oh, shit.
What's up?
Yes. It looks like you just got done fucking. What is going on? What is going on?
I gotta show you. Let me fix this.
What's up,
George? Just busted old pines and nuts.
How's everyone doing? Okay. Come on, you're the biggest clown.
You think so?
No. Sure. But it's a good thing. What are you guys laughing at?
So there's what we were just talking about. This clown. There's lovable clowns, and then there's the bad clowns. the fucking clown shoes, if you will, ass clowns.
Catherine, this is for you.
But hey, Kitty, what did you say, Joey?
There's oh my god, it looks like what the fuck? He's down.
He asked for four pitiful pearls, so I pulled out four pitiful pearl because I got three.
Hold on, so, Kitty, I'm gonna go into another part of the house. Let me grab something. Hold on.
George's gonna pull out his dick. It's really. I was saying that there's good clowns and bad clowns.
Do you remember when I wore the clown makeup and I ate the Carolina Reaper?
I do. You ate the hot fucking peppers. I also remember you had like your version of the little Debbie treats. You ate those also.
Oh, do you remember when I went in the shower as well, dressed?
Yeah, up? You did a shower. Fuck yeah, I do. Dude, it was some classic Lou moments before the Lou, if you will.
I'm not Dan.
I'm not Dan. Yeah. For those of you that are new here, I'm not Dan. Mm-hmm. All right, here he is.
So it's better I don't show you. I have actually a collection of dolls, but I'm not going to show you because
moderate to severe Crohn's disease.
God damn, who's got Crohn's in this bitch? What the fuck? Crohn Mafia.
I guess I want to show you these. Hi, Lewis.
Shout out to the Crows.
Hey,
George. Hello, George.
So look what came in, guys. I'm so excited. I was showing Joey earlier. This big ass box came in.
Oh, shit. Balenciaga.
And here you go. Look at these boots.
Oh, shit. Came in, yeah.
Damn.
Those look nice.
Those are fucking smooth. Those are probably my favorites, George. I think I told you that.
Look how big they are.
That's what she said. I took the abominable cannoli in that bitch.
Put them on. Give us a show.
Good times, Kat. George, can you walk around in them in just your briefs? Kind of just stomp through the house? Can you take your shirt and just keep the briefs?
But I want to give you an idea.
Okay.
Let me show you.
Santa ain't got nothing on these black boots.
This is
George sending dick pics of his boots. That looks, yeah, that's crazy.
About 14 inches.
Familiar, but not quite.
Hold on, there, look at that.
Those boots are more than my mortgage. Shout outs to mortgages, skills.
Look at that heel.
It's 5 inches up.
It's a BBB, man. Big black boot.
And this here.
I'd be scared I'd ruin them with that fabric.
13 inches high.
The average size in the mafia, if you will.
It looks like you can snuggle them. They're so fuzzy.
Fuzzy Wuzzy was a bear.
I had to ship it to myself because it wouldn't fit in my suitcase. It took up the whole thing. I bought these in... I bought these at Balenciaga in Brussels.
Little Brussels action.
So here, let's go. Let's see what this looks like.
Those boots were made for fucking. That's just what they'll do. One of these days, these boots are gonna cuckold all of you. Wait, what's going on? They don't make those boots for
torture?
What the fuck? Oh my god, he's actually in his boxes. All right, hold on a second.
That's how they were meant to be worn.
Ready? George, you better rip the fucking runway.
Let's go, George. Woo! Look at George.
Okay, here we go. George, I want you to dance around fucking Saltburn style. Here we go.
Like what?
There it is. What if his cock is like, yeah. Can you walk like from the picture all the way towards us? Stop. Boom. Stop. Sashe. And boom. Ooh. God damn. Look at the girth. Balenciaga, ooh.
Look at those cats.
So who says that this is a girl? Look at this. Where else do you get culture? You get
fashion. You get it all over here.
You get Trouble, you get.
Good luck.
You get Lewis, you get Montrese. I mean, where else can you get this?
Where are you going to get it? Yeah, we got everything from everywhere.
Well, the most dynamic range.
It's a great dynamic range.
Very unique individuals.
Unique individuals.
Where are you going to get this? Nowhere.
You're just not going to find this kind of shit lying around. This is crazy. George, tell us about the girth of the boots.
What do you mean?
Can you fit in the... Yeah. I'd like to put my hand and kind of slide it in there.
So, you want to fist your boot.
Yeah, I want to fist your boot, your gooch. Right. Wow.
Wait,
George, you got big hands. You think mine would fit?
Yeah. They're big, but you're looking at...
What the fuck does this even mean? Is y'all calling me ugly? Beautiful people and Joey? What
the fuck? 6 inches across. This is a big boot.
That's a big boot. Those are big boy boots.
Those
I would bust. Good. I would bust a nut on those boots. Dan said SpongeBob boots. Come on.
SpongeBob squeaky boots.
Squeaky fucking boots.
I'm gonna have a problem.
George got them boots with the fur.
Right, you know, the whole stream was looking at her. He hit the flow. Next thing you know, we saw his ass. Ho. Could you imagine?
Like, when I like go and get something, I get excited. Do you know?
Right. Yeah. Like retail therapy, you get a rush of endorphins.
And then Balmain, the house called me, and they're like, "Are you here for the shows?" And I'm like. Because we have a ticket for you with Antonia. We got 2 tickets for you, and I'm like, no, like as if like I'll be going to the shows in Paris. Do you know what I mean?
Right.
It's like, why didn't you tell me? I would have flown to Paris to go to the shows. Wouldn't you go?
I would go if I could, if someone invited me. Yeah.
And so, anyway, when I was in my 20s, I used to go to the shows in Milan, the men's shows, and that was just another world. But and then when I finished school. I went and did, and then I'll shut up. I'll let you guys go. I went and did, at that time it was PricewaterhouseCoopers as a consultant. And they said, you know, next time for the third interview, you might want to dress a little conservative. And I'm like, isn't Valentino Couture?
Is that not conservative?
Right?
Right.
I said that too. Valentino Couture, is that conservative?
Right. Get the fuck out of here. The Balmain unicorn sneakers.
I can't fit in those. They're too many.
Nobody's inviting you, Joey.
The Joey, like I would invite Joey to
like where would you take me? Like a St. Vinny the Pools kind of thing? Like
it would have to be I'm sorry, Joey. It would have to be like this was like a make a wish.
I always say like a fucking make a wish. I would have to be like,
you know, like that with you.
It's sure. Okay. Yeah, listen, when you wish upon a stream, you know. Anyways.
Great to fly first class with you and have you work the seats and all that and the food. And I think
right, kind of. Dude, you know how fun it'd be, like entertainment-wise?
I think it'd be funny.
It would be funny.
Yeah.
Hometown buffet. What? Cheesy with the drip as always says Kayleen. Who's Kayleen S?
Hi, Kayleen. Call me.
Yeah, call me daddy. How does this make you feel, George?
I'm who is that?
Wow.
Shout out to Kayleen's.
Yeah, I know a Kayleen.
Me too.
That's some picture that you guys took, right?
Yeah.
That's an AI picture, isn't it?
No! It's real.
Is that some concert you went to? That's Juju and the Plaid. I can't see. I'm not wearing my glasses, but where are you?
Motherfucker.
All right. Good night, guys. So
you fucking edges.
What?
He's just gonna leave. That's the end. You come on here, you steal our fucking hearts, and you just leave us high and dry.
Do you remember in that movie?
That's me, goddammit.
Wall Street.
The Wolf of Wall Street or Wall Street? The
movie Wall Street.
Yeah, yeah, they had the two seats.
They were in Central Park, and they were. She was saying, like, I can't go back. Remember? She was like, the worst thing.
Right.
Right. And I think that, like, if you were to fly first class, I think that you'd have a difficult time, like.
Like, ever going back. Kind of like once you. Out of respect, of course, once you go. I can't even say it. Montrese, what am I trying to say here?
I didn't even catch it, bro. I had to grab some water.
There's that line, once you go, you never.
No, once you go black, you never go back.
So George is saying once you get a taste of the other side, you're spoiled. It's never the same after that.
Right.
Is that Aretha? Who is it?
That's me. That's me.
Where is Fred Savage? Ben Savage. Savage is the brother.
It's like saying, like, once you get the expensive dolls, you can't just go get Barbie.
Oh, shit.
George would tell all his friends Joey was retarded, so to limit the embarrassment. That's a crazy comment.
We don't use
that. That's crazy.
Kennedy.
Yeah, we don't say such awful things over here. This is a family. This is a PC stream. Pay for two seats. Yeah, no shit.
Special needs.
As I love the whispering, by the way. What the fuck? Anyways, George, you have fun earlier? Did you have fun with me on this?
So, in all seriousness, Joey knows I love him. I don't know what it is. He's got a soft spot in my heart, but all you guys have been here for 4 years. You guys also know. So, Joey, I love you so much.
Yeah. I wonder if anyone, loves me. I heard Julissa say, bitch.
And I have to fight Juju with, I mean, like, I'm the third spouse, right?
In the family. Right. One big happy family, if you will.
All right, go enjoy your night. Love you guys.
All right, George, take it easy. Thanks for murdering the dance floor. Ladies and gentlemen, here he goes, GP.
Hey Joey, can I give a quick warning to people? Right. Please. For each clown of the week that we get, each of the clowns get their own t-shirt from now
on. Yeah, this is a great fucking shirt. So clown of the week for January 30th, 2024, the creeper. Some may call him the drunken creep.
You're going to have thousands and thousands of people walking around with your face on their t-shirts. So you want to avoid that.
Finally know what it's like to have friends. That's beautiful.
I mean,
Dog, CK, it's fucking crazy. I told Topanga, I was like, can I? I didn't even like, I wasn't even going to touch her. You know what I mean? Because, like, I just think so many creepy dudes kind of just put their hands on them. And like cross boundaries, and I was like, can I put my arm around? Like, can I touch? Like, can I? It was crazy. It was fucking crazy. The fact, yeah, Julissa, Topanga. I looked at it, I said, honey, it's in God's hands. And this is only one photo. We have like six or seven. There's one of just me and Topanga. Like, we're not gonna talk about it. But Julissa loved Sean Hunter. So I said, honey, this is it. You go over here. I go over there. Will Friedle, of course, out of respect. Big Boy Meets World fan. I went 90s, of course. Julissa and I dressed up 90s. And shout outs to the plastic cups or the paper cups, right? The Dixie cup design. The jazz design is what it was called. Yeah, it's Has anybody seen Jason?
Joey Cannoli, Eric Matthews here. Let's clear a couple of things up, okay? Number one, you are the king of Fragcom. Number two, Topanga has always loved you. Well, until she fell for Juju. And if you're watching this, kiss the ring and embrace the cannoli. Cannoli Mafia for life.
I mean, what else do you want?
Yeah.
I said, can I put my arm around you? I was trying to be funny. Oh, what did Topanga smell like? Peaches. Yeah, like a fruity floral is what she smelled like. It's funny that we're in Fraycom, so I can genuinely answer that. Like a fruity floral. I was actually trying to smell all those motherfuckers. I know that sounds weird, but like... and you know what I wore? Mikey Denz's Untamed Addiction. Is that what it's called? It was Baccarat mixed with Abercrombie Fierce. Just a fucking savage. Really good job. Oh, yeah! When I was walking away, he yelled Cannoli Mafia for life, and I'm pretty sure I blushed. I couldn't, like, I turned into a bitch. Montrese, dog, listen, I had butterflies, bro. And that's the gayest shit you're ever gonna hear me say. Because I didn't, like, he remembered. He knew who the fuck I was. It was the craziest, one of the coolest things I've ever, like, experienced. Like, I don't know, man. I'll never forget it. I get tingles, Montrese. In a non-gay way, I get the tingles.
I think it was more than that, man.
What are you talking about?
I feel like you probably got aroused by that shit.
Are you saying that I got like a little hard, like a little erection, Montrese?
And if you did, it's okay.
I swear, it is okay. But I didn't. I didn't. Yeah. There it is. I can't stop looking.
I think it's dope, man. You should get that shit and, you know, and just get that shit put on the wall, bro. I don't see why you wouldn't.
I totally would. That's actually not the gayest shit you've ever. I genuinely believe that, Skells. Not even fucking around. I've said some pretty gay shit over the years. You'll probably catch me at my gayest when I'm on, like, when I was on Omegle, because part of the fodder was fucking with the straight dudes, talking to them gay, because you could, like, some of them just gave a golden reaction. It is plausible, out of respect. Just I got the tingles in my tummy, you know, tummy, what is it called, tummy sticks. Anyways, who was Eric Matthews? That was Sean's, or Corey's brother, his older brother. He was like the funny one on the show. He was the slacker.
Oh, dare you not know who that is?
Yeah, that's crazy.
That's
a crazy comment to even hear. Anyways, yeah, I just, you know, is there any toxicity left? Does it even matter anymore, ladies and gentlemen? 35 people at the 1 hour, 12 minute mark. Boy Meets World.
Shout outs to Corey. I know he was tripping, but shout out.
Yeah, he was tripping. That's crazy. He doesn't even talk to him anymore. He's doing the politic thing. Montrese, what do you think? What do you know how many likes we got on this after party stream?
I'm about to look.
Let's take a fucking look.
Take a look.
It's in a book. It's reading rainbow. Duncan's on timeout. Who's Eric Matthews?
Well, that's a...
What are we looking at here?
I see 17. That's unacceptable.
This is a great comment. 17? We got 40 people fucking watching. All right. Guys, even if you're lurking, even if you hate watching or you're waiting for drama, you're here waiting. You're here. You could be doing anything else with your time. Leave a like on the video. We're also at the 1 hour and 13 minute mark. Who's going to be the first one to put it right there tonight? PayPal.me/UGB93. Because it's murder on the dance floor. We're doing clown of the week. Fuck with it.
I'm
fucking insane.
Guys, I've got a question. How familiar are you guys with Paul Robertson? Because I don't know who he is, but I've been talking to him every day on a group chat for days.
So first of all, Paul Robinson, fellow Wisconsinite, I swear Paul used to come around a lot more years back. And now there's been a resurgence, which is nice. We were able to rekindle. Clown on the dance floor, of course. Good to see the creep.
Well, I didn't know where he was from.
The Boz. Yeah, we're in the Boz group. Yeah. Boz group. Paul, a big fan of Boz and other individuals. It's good to see some people from the olden days, if you will. I've been in FrayCon maybe 2 years.
What's up?
2.5 years. There you go. 2.5 men. That's a great name for a gay porn. 2.5 men. What happened? They got rid of Charlie Sheen when he was high on Tiger Blood and cocaine, and they put Ashton Kutcher. I know it's Kutcher. I like calling him Kutcher. That was a show. Kishi K, you collect dolls. You're a mommy. Little Susie home, you know, homemaker, if you will. But what is you unwinding? Is this it? How do you cut loose, Kishi K?
This is about as loose as
So you enjoy your time here. You have a little smoke action. Yeah. You laugh. Are you going to be rapping for us tomorrow night?
Yeah, I just need to practice. Not a fan of Meg Thee Stallion, by the way. Team Nicki Minaj all the way.
Would be a little person.
I tried to rap Meg Thee Stallion. She is not on the beat. She sounds terrible. She says the N-word every 5 seconds.
Say dial so many times. You know, Kay, Meg Thee Stallion and Nicki Minaj are having a big beef going on right now.
I know. Team Nicki.
Yeah, I don't know. Listen, I like Meg Thee Stallion, but Nicki will always be the queen. It's crazy to even.
You know who always be the queen to me?
Go on now.
Little Kim.
Classic. Taking it way back, huh?
Yep.
Yeah, Little Kim
was nasty. I wish she kept her pretty face, though. She was so pretty.
Right.
But you know what, though? Meg Thee Stallion, when she first came out, She was better. She was way better.
She had a song with Nicki Minaj in like 2019, I think.
Yeah, but you know how it is. But see, Nicki, she beefs with everybody. That's just her thing. She did
it with. She's also been around a long time, and she kind of had her time in the sun, even though she'd be considered a legend. Meg Thee Stallion's kind of the new Nicki Minaj. I hate to say it.
But you know, she did it with everybody. She did it with Iggy Azalea. She did it with Erykah Banks. She does it with everybody. That's Nicki just.
Did she do it with Cardi B?
She did it with Cardi. When Cardi first got big, she dropped her second mixtape, and then things got crazy. But, you know, she does it with everybody. You know what I'm saying? I'm used to it. But now, when she took that shot at Remy Ma, that was a mistake. You know what I'm saying? Because Remy Ma is her bar. You just can't out rap Remy Ma. But
now, Montrese, Duncan has a crazy comment. Ben Shapiro, if you guys aren't familiar who Ben Shapiro is, politic guy, was recently in a music video, a rap song, Tom McDonald.
Can I say I hate Tom McDonald?
You hate Tom McDonald.
He made fun of mentally incapable people, special needs people, and that has stuck with me for years. And I will not forgive him doing that thing where he was making fun of them.
Break it down. I'm not familiar with this story.
So I don't remember if it was a song or a TikTok or something.
He was making fun of mentally challenged people.
Mentally challenged people. I used to like him because he would rap and stuff, but then he made fun of mentally challenged people, and I was like, all right, you're done.
What did he... Should we look up what he...
I don't want to do it. He did like a... You know when you act like you make weird faces and
like the hand gestures. They do the hand thing, like
yeah, like you're pretending to have a seizure. That's what he was doing.
Famous YouTuber, Suck It Up Buttercup. So the reason I'm saying this is I want to play Ben Shapiro's rap that he did with Tom McDonald 4 days ago. It's almost got 10 million fucking views. And
who's that guy?
Oh, shit.
Who is it?
Twisted Insane.
Okay, that's what I thought it was.
He was making fun of liberals, says Duncan. I actually take Duncan's word because I know I would imagine Duncan's a big fan of Tom McDonald, and it maybe I wouldn't even classify it as rap. Well, that's why a lot of people have been laughing at it, but Nicki Minaj kind of gave him a shout out. That's Julian, says Lord My Tech. Duncan, you can like what you like, but those guys are pathetic dickwads. So I'm gonna play it because it's kind of going viral and the rap is fucking crazy. Let me put my headphones in because
yeah, I'm saying about it on a sort of saying about it on Facebook.
Did you hear it, Lou? Have you heard the rap itself?
No.
All right, here we go. So this is making waves online. Now I don't know when it kicks in. Here, I'll just jump here. So I'm gonna share. I'm not going to play the video, but I'm going to play the music. All right, let's share screen. There we go. So you see I have the video up.
Let's look at the stats. I've got the facts. My money like Lizzo, my pockets are fat. Homie, I'm epic. Don't be a wap. Dog, it's a yarmulke. Homie, no cap. Hey. The grass. Look at my charts. You're blowing money on strippers and cars. You go into prison. I'm on television. Dog, no one knows who you are. Keep hating on me on the internet. My comment section all woke Karens. And I make racks off compound interest. Y'all live with your parents. Nigga, no. Take some notes. I just did this for fun. All my people download this. Let's get a billboard number one.
This ain't rap. This ain't money. Cars and clothes.
Okay. I'm a 100. It was better than I thought, but it was as cringy as I knew it would be.
Yeah, man, I was about to vomit, but I had to catch myself.
That is the craziest Caucasoid combo.
That was weak as fuck.
Well, first of all, he's not a rapper, right? He does politics stuff, and I see his videos all the time online. Ben Shapiro, I'm talking about. Real quick.
I see you, Lewis. Shout out to Twisted Insane, man. They don't know nothing about Twisted Insane, my dude.
Yeah, I was lucky enough to get him on a song. It's one of my biggest achievements.
You should drop the song so we can all hear it.
Ooh. No, we won't do that.
Are you sure? I maybe we do. Maybe we need some good shit after whatever that was.
I don't know. I don't want to take the spotlight, but my YouTube channel is The Real Arm Lewis, and I've got more shit on the way.
Okay, and we can find this. I like that Gail Lewis comes up. That's funny. Walmart associate.
You know, he does lives.
Yeah.
Yeah, I done popped in a couple times. He's cool as shit.
Mm-hmm.
Cool.
Why is it not coming up? What the fuck's going on?
It's in all caps.
Oh, maybe that's it. Yeah, I definitely know.
No spaces.
Right. Okay, I had to do all caps. Oh, shit. All right, let's give it a listen. Featuring Twisted Insane. What? Hold on. Let me change my audio. Let's. It's just. Is it a video? Just a picture?
Just a picture.
Okay, let's listen. Here we go. This is Lewis, ladies and gentlemen. The real I'm Lewis with Twisted Insane. It's called World So Cold. I hope. Is this okay, Lou? I'm gonna play this.
We're doing it.
All right, here we go. I'm gonna turn it up.
Yo, let me tell you a story. There once was a little kid, his name was Antoine. A father he lamented about the fact he never had one. He woke up every morning sad and on the verge of tears, because the planet Earth around him was a playground for his fears. Dark and evil, anxious around all the scary people. Dark thoughts of messed up panic left him brittle and feeble, plus they were teasel. The insecurities he felt inside about the way he looked, the way he never thought but would go higher. Only 12 years old and expected to be bold, and expected not to be fazed by pressure so cold. As he rose, he left his bed contorted and shaking, apprehensive about the torture that he'd finally be facing. You see, Antoine would be brooded every day of his life, when walking to school, when he got there, and on the way back on his back. They would steal the money that he stole to buy him some lunch, so he turned to the bin so he could have a daily packed lunch that was crushed by the books in his bag. English and math, he was glad, cause that's all that he had. Antoine would bury all his fears in his books. He loved to study, it distracted him from his life of torment and no money. See the bullies, they thought Antoine was meaningless. An IQ of 145 and a full-blown genius. He had dreams to find a cure to cancer. The kids would tease and say they slept with his mum. Last night they rang her. He was bullied by the kids and the teachers didn't care. How could they when they didn't know, cause they were never there. And not to mention, do you know what makes this all worse? His parents used to beat him too, but leaving him hurt. Now on the verge, think about it. No love from the people around you, the people that made you, you're feeling no worse. So he's getting to the point of fantasy is unearthed. He wants to kill himself, be laid to rest 6 feet under dirt.
Journey with the man on the bad block. Money in the hand with a fat Glock. Living in a world that's full of evil. That's what I was thinking when I saw him serve his dad with the crack rock. Number got me knocking up the pad with the padlock. Hurry up, they about to double back, get your man shot. Bodies on top of bodies and everybody crying. About to release your business and around that you can't stop. I'm surrounded by the evil now. No joke, real smoke, last demon chow. Tayo told me that there wasn't no hope. Never sold dope ever since I was a juvenile. Now Johnny ain't seen his dad for a couple weeks. Told him he was about to get the bag at the double tree. Never ain't heard from his ass and he wondering. What the fuck is that? Did it that? He was stuttering. Then he got to running and nobody ever heard from him since. Shit, doesn't make sense. Someone said they found him at the store trying to get 5 cents. Just trying to pay rent. Maybe he look about the same, but his mind done went. Shit, time was spent sitting with his dad looking at the same bag of shit. Fuck, trimming on lint. Now we're on the bathroom floor looking at the razor. Fuck, here we go again. Hoping at the end all days and take away the pain. Stepping at the bottom of the hen. Trying to take his life that night. Don't feel right. Only 21 years old. Now we're in the ground looking at the body got found when you're living in a world so cold.
Let me check. Hold on. Let me fix the audio quick.
What? You guys? What you think?
Can we back? Can we back?
That was Twisted Insane.
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm.
Hell yeah. Super shout outs. Well, that was definitely when you go from Ben Shapiro rapping to World So Cold, it's a crazy fucking contrast. you can't compare that. Lou's channel is The Real I'm Lewis. I'm going to drop the link right now so you guys can sub. UK rapper. There it is. Let's fucking go. How you doing, Cap? All right. Go over there and sub to our boy. Contrast of the week we could do. Something really good, something really bad. And just fucking. We got Clown of the Week. Captain, we started a new thing, Clown of the Week. I feel like I'm glad that Lewis came back as Captain Coke.
Glad to be back. Shout out to Captain Coke.
Super shout outs, Captain and Coke. Montrese, you know, you're a bit of a controversial character, if you will. Clown of the Week. Do you have anybody in your back pocket for future reference?
But like I said earlier, man, there's always a clown, you know. In my book, you know, racist people are state clowns. But see, Whiskey was already a clown, man, because when you're friends with pedophiles, You stay a clown. He's always been that way.
Jackass. When he came up,
you know, he's a jackass. When he came up here on that bullshit, he was a jackass that night. Besides everything else, though, it was the father shit for me. That's it, bro. Like, you know what I'm saying?
I got a lot of love for you guys, and I know you fucking care, because you guys are affected more by it than I am, and that's because you care, right? It's because you genuinely care. Because when I see how everyone's reacting and I hear the words and the way you guys expressing yourself, it's like, I think that's what he wanted, right? It was to get angry or to get emotional or to get, to get defensive, to be like, oh, I got him. Scout says, I don't care. Who's the bridge clown of the week? The bridge of the week? If we could tiptoe around it, we could make it a thing. Jackass of the week. We have clown of the week. Bridge of the week, Montrese. Who's on the bridge this week?
Shit, there's Whiskey Reaper.
There you go. That's because we root for you, Captain. Loyal, I love it. Respect. Shout out to the Mafia. Toxic Tuesdays just aren't what they used to be. Do we leave it in the past? I swear, when I try to do a Toxic Tuesday, I don't get the toxic. When I don't do it, it has a way of finding every nook and cranny possible and just squeezing its way in there.
The thing is, Joe, because of last night, I think a lot of the anger and the
it was out.
Yeah, this is like this that isn't is this is like 2.0, like one, like 2.0. It's not the main Toxic Tuesday.
So two days of toxicity never translate well.
I don't think so, to be honest.
You may be onto something, Lou, because. I mean, I got nothing, right? We addressed. I mean, I love the, of course, the photo. Kishy K says she has no toxicity, nothing, no hot gas. Montrese, anything?
Yeah, what's up?
Any toxicity you'd like to address?
Nah, I said all I had to say, about the alcoholic Whiskey Reaper. That's all I had to say, bro.
Remember when Remington tried to cancel Toxic Tuesday? I nominate him for next week's Clown of the Week. You know what's really funny? Like, those guys loved the toxicity. They were the trolls themselves. They were the instigators, the manipulators, the spinsters. So it's really funny to also play the card of, like, we got to cancel Toxic Tuesday. How could you do this? While also sitting there kind of snickering like a child, provoking it. Where to me that makes me laugh. Anyone could see through all that facade and all that bullshit. I found it funny. Kay has become a staple of the Mafia. I am a fan. She is our mutant of the year, of course. And Kay has given us some legendary moments. Kay also raps on karaoke night. Has great dial fodder. Has been victimized this past month.
I got rid of those racist dolls today. But I got a big black one on the way that's a little bit different.
Never say a big black one again, okay?
I can go next to her. She'll
right. I got a big black one on the way, ladies and gentlemen.
Joey, you'd have all kinds of fun with the BBC News over.
Oh, of course, the British Broadcasting, right? Is that's what BBC stands for?
British Broadcasting Company.
Yeah. Not the big black cock. I do like, I think it's, I'm certainly not the first one to make that joke. Big Shirley. Yeah, let me tell you a story. You want me to get toxic for a suck? Like, listen, Big Shirley really disappointed the shit out of me, Spence. I'm going to tell you why. I sent Big Shirley a link last week. She immediately replied, was excited, said she was going to come through. She never showed up last Wednesday. Nofia showed up. But I wanted Nofia to meet Big Shirley because I thought contrast of the week would be fucking chaotic. Just two different walks, two different cut. Just they're both cut from a different cloth, if you will.
Are they both from 2020? I don't recognize.
Oh, they're both new. These are the mutants of the month, if you will. Who does it go to? Nofia? Big Shirley? I'm gonna give it to Pickles.
Well, I've actually heard of, I've heard of and seen Pickles, so.
I personally like Nofia the best.
Okay. Montrese is straight up loyal, never wavered, great guy. Initially, I was hesitant, but Captain is warmed up. Kay is a funny sister. She got kids. Give her a break. Now, listen, I don't know if it was the kids. Oh, shit. Hot take. Toxic take. Nofia fucking sucks. Nofia's a rock star. Pickles is where it's at. If I had to pick Mutant of the Month, it'd go to Pickles. What about you, Kishy K? Nofia for Mutant of the Month. Do you not want Pickles to take your Mutant of the Year award?
Oh, I don't give a crap if she takes it, but I like Nofia.
I think the titty lamp above her head fell on her, so she might be in the hospital. You sound so stupid when you say that. I hate her haircut. Who are you talking about, my tech?
That was fun.
Yeah, I liked the Big Shirley. You know, Big Shirley, you know what would have been a real meeting of the minds? Big Shirley meeting, what's her name? Pocahontas? Puff? What's her name? What's the bitch's name? The one that lost her fucking mind last Friday. Oh my God.
Hippie?
Pippi Longstocking. Yeah, Hippie. Crazy.
Oh, come on, man. We because if RXL wasn't there, we would have said, oh, I wish we had Hippie and RXL, but no, we actually had it, and it was crazy.
It was phenomenal. I wish we could have got Hippie and Big Shirley against each other. That would have been fucking chaos.
I don't know, bro. Listen, you know, if RXL, because see, and I said this, I've never went on mute so many times. A girl fucked herself when people came over here and spammed the chat. That's when I was like, damn, like she.
The worst part for me is the racist remarks when she was black.
Yeah, but she had already said a lot of dumb shit before RXL came over here. I liked her at first, but then I got turned off.
You don't like her at first, Montrese.
I liked her at first.
The arrogance of Nofia makes my asshole. So Nofia is cocky. She's young and cocky. Can we blame her? She knows she's beautiful. She knows
that. Like that and could sing like that, I'd be fucking cocky too.
I don't think you would be.
No.
I think you'd be humble, Kay.
Yeah, you do gotta humble yourself. I mean, I like Nofia though.
I like Nofia.
But you can't expect, like, again, she's young, you know, she knows she's cute, but again, this is, you know, just the suburban attitude, you know what I'm saying? But
where is she? Right.
Where's Nick been, more importantly?
Listen, I tried to call him a couple days ago. He never picked up. I really don't know what's going on, guys.
I reached out to him and I said, oh, a few people are trying to get a hold of you and they can't. I said, I hope you're doing well. I never heard back. And usually I do hear back. So.
See, that makes me nervous.
I've been nervous.
Yeah, I bet we've been nervous the last few weeks. Where is Sage been? Sage is being a fucking baby. And I'm going to tell you why. I sent Sage a message, which I normally don't reply. But I sent Sage a link at, I go, Kay wants you to hop on stream. A guy is willing to shave his head if women come on. And smoke. Sage comments at 10:05, I'm busy. Bitch, we know you're laying in bed doing absolutely nothing. Bitch, we know you're sitting there snacking it the fuck up, doing absolutely fucking nothing. If you're going to tell me at 10:11, you're fucking busy, I can only imagine you're eating, bitch, okay? You're fucking busy eating. That's unacceptable. You won't hear me talk shit like that too often, but you're going to tell me you're busy? What are you on the last fucking combo? You got three corn nuts left until the bait's gone? Don't ever fucking talk to me. That's I'm sorry. I'm fucking pissed. You know what I mean? You're busy. Are you cleaning your fucking floor that Captain told you to clean? Or did a fucking meatball roll off of your plate and go out the fucking door and chase after it? Don't ever. I'm busy. The fuck? You see what happened? Now I'm upset. You guys happy? Now I'm toxic. Joey's cocky all the time, and y'all don't hold it against him. Quit shaming the woman for being confident. I've never said some crazy shit like that.
Listen. Listen. The comment that you just read, I gotta say this, bro. If you're in the mafia, and the mafia is ran by Joe Pesci 2.0, would you say anything?
Sage eating a burrito the size of Nacho Vidal's cock. All I'm saying is you're not fucking busy. Okay? Nobody's fucking busy at this time of the night.
Definitely not.
What were you doing? You got IKEA eating fucking meatballs to put a, you know what I mean? I'm sorry, Montrese. Go ahead. See what happens.
No, you good, bro. You know, not IKEA, you know, meatballs on the couch. You know, this
out of respect.
Yeah. We know she's not busy. But you know, she wants you to believe that she is. That's all.
She wants to believe that she's got more important things going on. I think she's picked up on the smoke she gets on stream because of how she is, and I think she got a little fed up from it, which means she's not willing to be better, which means she doesn't feel responsible. She's not holding herself accountable for being a stream killer. You know what I mean? For telling multiple stories, 22 stories, multiple lies. And I think she realized every time I come here, I just get smoked. And I think after a while, if people refuse to, you know, look outside or look within, if you will, they just say, you know what, fuck you. It took 5,000 insults to find out Skells. Yeah, no shit. Or excuse me, not Skells. I ain't afraid of Joey, says Skells. What are you talking about? Are you afraid of Nofia?
Who came first? Not so famous YouTuber or famous YouTuber?
That's a good fucking question. I don't know.
Well, I know that Duncan had the other name before that. What was it? Fritz the Cat.
Fritz the Cat is how I remember Duncan.
I remember, yeah, because I remember him on Eugene's stream.
Oh, that's probably why. That means Spence came first.
Right, okay.
I knew Dunk before I was not so. Spence is the OG. I will use Sage as a float if the ship goes down. That's crazy. The Titanic 2.0.
That's fucked up.
I'll never let the mafia go. A great comment that I don't mind reading. A little wild. Here we go. Kay, I think you're way sexier than Nofia with all your anal technology and props, says Marcus Mandel. There's a compliment in there somewhere. But yes, I think the anal technology is very futuristic. I think the mafia is an equal opportunist. And yeah, Fritz the Cat, Sage floats, Magenta asks the wave of the future, some people are saying in the chat.
It was Fritz the Cat and Rudy that I knew from Eugene's stream before I met him, which is kind of weird, like, to like know of someone and then like become friends with him. It's a bit of a unique thing, but live streams made that possible, I guess. I don't know.
The streams are responsible for a lot of crazy shit.
The Suicide Squad.
What? God damn it, Montrese. What are you doing watching Suicide Squad? Yeah,
Crohn's disease earlier. No,
right, first motherfuckers out here with the Crohn's, the Crohn Mafia. Now we're the Suicide Squad. That game's coming out, right? I heard that they're already dropping the price. It must be buggy.
That game is trash.
Is it trash?
I've already got the player early. That game is, and I know it's going to be even worse.
It's going to be like God.
It's one of them games that you just know is going to be trash. Like, even me playing an early build, I'm like, this game is trash. I'm not interested. I don't want it. I don't think it's going to sell like that.
You think it's going to be like $20 before the, like, spring is here?
Yeah, that game, man, it's not about to boom.
Captain, I don't play video games. There you go.
Captain, you 85 years old, man.
What? Listen, Captain was young when the Pong came out. I bet he played Miss
Pac-Man. But Captain, you know I love you, bro. I'm fucking with you. I bet
he played Miss fucking Pac-Man, kind of fucking around in the pizza shop. Hey, you know,
I still play Pac-Man, bro. I got all that nostalgia.
I got Miss Pac-Man machine hanging on my door in my fucking living.
Listen, bro, fuck all that. Bro, I still got my ColecoVision. I still got my ColecoVision, my dude. Like I love crazy. My whole shit.
Yeah, I found Nintendo. Myself. I found myself watching videos of a terrible game earlier. I sat for an hour and watched a walkthrough of WWF SmackDown 2 just for the nostalgia.
Are you out of your mind?
The
you said that was terrible. You Matt, disrespect. Whoa. What?
the nostalgia was there, and I just sat and watched it.
First of all, the nostalgia.
I thought you said it was terrible.
On my face. Kishi K giving us a review. Is this Sage, oh, the South African great elephant?
Oh, shit.
Holy fuck.
He used to be pink.
Can he really? Can he paint it gray?
Used to be. Well, why is he not Alex pink?
Monk was the shit. Shit.
You know,
was it Kay that said the mafia? Because or someone said that the mafia is the zoo, and it goes we have a South African great elephant. Was that Kay who said that?
I was just gonna think so.
That was one of your funniest lines, by the way. That was hilarious.
Man, that was savage. But you know, I want to move on. But I gotta go back a little bit. Did you say SmackDown 2 was a terrible game, Lewis?
Right. I say it was terrible because I thought everyone else thought it was terrible, but I kind of it. No?
Man, that game is fire, bro. It's No Mercy, WCW Revenge. But let's not do the game talk because people are going to leave.
They will leave. It will happen.
That's for a separate stream.
You know what I play a lot of, and I always say this, dude, you'll find me in VR. You want to find me? I'm in VR fucking around. Julissa and I probably play it almost every night together. But you know what I mean? We have a good time. I jerked off Chris out of respect, Montrese, of course. But I jerked off Chris the Canadian in VR. I think I had a big. I've showed the picture. Captain says riveting.
Yeah. Hey, Lewis, I said the same thing, but you know what?
It's not what you think. It's not the way you think. It was funny, because he had a big vagina costume with his avatar, and I had a big penis, and then I went over to...
Because isn't that how you met... that's gay.
It's the Canadian. Captain's saying that's gay, Joey. I mean, it is gay, Captain, yeah. Play VR riding your bike.
Is VR gay?
Right. There's a difference between VR gay... I agree with Montrese. Joey does like hand jobs. I give hand jobs. I don't enjoy getting them. In VR, I would jerk everyone off. The girl virtual gay. It's only gay in the AI, right? VR. So if you ever see me in VR and just pretend you don't know me, kind of shit.
Well, it's called virtual reality, so reality's still in there, so it does count. It's still gay.
So is it like is it kind of gay? Like
it's just another reality, but it's still real.
So in another reality, I'm gay.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, we can. Yeah. We'll meet halfway.
Are you a bi?
If you keep doing that gay shit in VR, you know who's gonna pop up in there.
Get the fuck out of here. What are you talking? You know who else is in VR? Is Pup Boy Lucas.
I'm not surprised. But you know, if you keep doing that shit, but shout out to Pup Boy Lucas. Little Nas X is going to pop up in there. So, you keep doing that.
I don't like that mantra.
And the other thing is, Joey, like, you'll become desensitized. You'll want more. And that's all. It always starts on VR.
It's a dangerous game, isn't it? It's a dangerous glue. Did you guys see that Black Mirror episode with the two guys?
No.
It was two black guys, Montrese, and they were best friends, and they would play fighting games. And then, they grew up. They got married, jobs, careers, whatever. But he's having a barbecue birthday party, I think, and he gives him this video game, and it's, of course, Black Mirror's all futuristic. He puts it on and he goes into like a VR world, and it's them, and he's playing as a chick and the other guy's playing as a dude, and they start kissing and fucking, and the one guy kind of falls. Dude, it's fantastic. I know it sounds like gay fodder, Montrese, but watch it.
You mentioned a character. Did you say butt fuck Lucas?
Come on.
I'm taking Axel's was coming and making it worse.
Pup boy Lucas.
Butt fuck Lucas.
It is the shit. I don't know if anyone here even knows what I'm talking about. It's from last season. It's fucking fantastic, Captain. You need to watch it. It'll blow your fucking mind. It's so good. It is so good. Like, they end up fighting at one point. Get the fuck out of here, Yutz. What are you saying to me? Get out of here. Pup boy Lucas.
I have a request, man. I need my boy BG to come here more often. The dude is cool as shit. He's hilarious.
Striking violence. Thank you.
Yeah, he got to come more often, man, because the two times I've seen him ain't enough. Dude is hilarious.
You think he could make a comeback? A lot of people are still on. I mean, listen, Kishi K, you know, BG played the retarded fodder with Big T, and I have a zero tolerance for that, you know? I don't like that kind of shit, and that's why I told him. And he wouldn't even apologize to Big T, so I kicked him out. Yeah. I guess never left, and he always watched, and he would comment. We're talking like a year. You know, a year of not being around. And then one day he just shows up. And I don't know if people forget after enough time or if they forgive, if it's even redeemable, but he slowly has been accepted by more and more by individuals in the mafia. Kishi K, what's your take on that?
I don't fuck with that shit.
You got a zero tolerance. She is that right?
Fuck with that bullshit, man.
You know, if you could, you would tell BG to kick rocks.
I would kick rocks at BG or whoever.
Right.
But you know why I say what I say is because there are quite a few bitches in the mafia. So I mean, him coming back is really not a big deal. You know what I'm saying? But I say this though. When that bullshit happened the other day, everybody band together. So I do respect that. Mm-hmm. Because that's what we're supposed to do. Because everybody's not gonna get along no matter what community, what family. In real life, it could be a family. Because I got two cousins right now, you know. It's two family members I got right now. You know, I kick them both off a bridge. You know what I'm saying?
Damn. He only came to sell his Aunt Jemima. You may be onto something. People forget. He's redeemable. He was just drunk. RXL, he's drunk every appearance. he's never not drunk when he comes here.
We can't make excuses for shit like that. That's right. What people have to stop doing. He was drunk. Well, you know, my grandma told me a long time ago, you know what I'm saying? When you're drunk, the truth come out. That's really who you are.
That's true. Now, with that being said, should we take and I want Chris the Canadian here, but should we take a vote on the, do we bring BG back? Is he on probation? Does Kishi K get to rip him a new one? What happens?
Joey, you got to remember BG versus DDLD. And for me, that just
yeah, I do remember that. You know, he was they had like a good thing going, the Odd Couple, if you will.
Yeah,
and then that's what happened. Well, the rest is history. Good to see Fatboy Fragrance. What's somebody's excuse when they're not drunk? Yes, he apologized.
I
think he did apologize. But it's too late now. Big T is
too Big T.
That's what I was about to say. He needs to apologize to Big T, not me. Like,
who gives a fuck what we all think is
Big T? Shit!
Like, that's fucked up. As somebody else who's a little like quirky and stuff, like, it's not okay.
So, Kishi K, if you were on the cannoli committee and you had a gavel, You're pretty much saying no. All right.
I mean, if he was really drunk and like, I mean, I can give people passes if they're really inebriated, you know, and they made like some weird slurred speech about something that didn't make sense, you know, and did it like during that. But, you know, that's like a, I don't know this person, so.
Yeah. CK says, I think he did. It's too late. Big T is gone. It's too late to apologize. So, shout out to One Republic.
It's too late to apologize.
Holding on a stream got me 10 feet off. When did K become a wise old Chinese lady? Says, that's crazy. Shout out to the Komodo. I like the drunk chick with the German guy. Yeah, that sucked. I missed the fucking, he looked like a fucked up Johnny Depp. The German had jaundice. Jaundice German.
It was cool, man. It's what somebody, who the fuck was that? Somebody was talking shit about him, and he was just like, you know what? I'm done. Like, because he came a couple of times, man. I wish he would come back. He was cool, man. And he was way back. Chased
him away, remember? She started
drunk,
like,
he had a drunk bitch.
Yeah. It's like we had two episodes. We had that, and then we had the German guy with Pippi Longstock, and what the fuck? I've seen Big T living his best life, not moving his head and looking dazed. I always remember him in his chair. Listen, listen. In the words of Oasis, Lou, don't look back in anger, huh? Bye. Timbaland made certified bangers. Yeah, he did. I like Timbaland.
I know what it was now. She was talking about his face. And,
he spoke about his face, and he was creepy. Yeah. She said that he creeped her out. Then she started going, like, telling him to, like, did she tell him to speak English and his accent? It was, it was coming off real racist, huh? It was crazy.
It was one thing that
get the fuck out of here! Come on, come on.
I gotta take it easy.
Come on, take it easy.
But it was but he did say one thing that made me laugh my ass off. He said, you know, and that I can't do the accent, but he's like, who the fuck are you?
Yeah, he was kind of fucked up.
But he was like, who the fuck are you? Like, when he said that to her, like, who the fuck are you? Now, I was dying laughing, bro.
Yeah, one of the greatest moments, though, Montrese, is when we did it was a morning stream. Big T flat out took a shit live. No one told him to do it. He just took a shit, and it was such an awful shit. I wish Blondie was here. Chris the Canadian also. He took the most haggard shit, and then he covered it up with toilet paper like a cat covers it with the litter. And I'm like, yo, we ain't never have a cat shit on the stream before. Like that, like I've had so much fuck shit over the years go down here. And I'm not saying people forget, but sometimes you got to revisit. Big T dropped a big shit.
he actually did that another time when Dan was on. Because he could tell you sitting on the toilet, and then you went, are you taking a shit? And then he nodded, and Dan just
laughed. He was proud of it, right? Yeah.
Yeah. It's on one of the highlight videos on Channel 69. Fuck.
Damn, those we had. Hey, it was fun while it lasted, huh? Mm-hmm. Fuck. Yeah.
Big T loved that video because he was a massive part of it, and he even put in the comments that he was so excited about the video.
And he was so proud he did the tubby time where he'd put the bubbles on his titties. And I used to love when the workers would come in and he'd turn his camera off because he knew, right? And they'd wash his hair and help him. Big T dropping them logs. Yeah. Yeah. Oh, my God. Yes, public shit was crazy. The stream shit was out of control. And I remember his bath water had a strange color to it also. I don't know. But anyways, back to what we were saying, Kishy K. The DB, BG, STD, XYZ. Are you saying there's a possibility that he could redeem himself? Unfortunately, he is gone, Big T, and he did apologize.
Yeah, I mean, if it was really a drunk situation, then, I mean, I can understand maybe being super inebriated. I just mean, I personally would never do that while I'm inebriated, but maybe somebody
who is,
else.
Who is this mother? Who is this guy? Great. That's exactly the color. Who are you, you motherfucking burner? You burning son of a bitch. Who are you?
Do you know what the picture is? Because, I don't know.
From a movie? TV show? Listen, all I'm saying is that's exactly it. It had a gray bluish, almost like a windshield washer fluid. Real fucked up shit. I've never seen nothing like it in my life.
It must have had like a blue raspberry freeze.
You're right.
And Taco Bell.
Joey, remember he farted? Taco Bell. Joey, remember he farted also that day? Yeah, he was ripping ass. He used to, like, in the mornings, all of the people would be there. He'd be having breakfast. He'd knock back, like, was it a 24-hour stream where he ate, like, 6 or 7 fucking sandwiches? It was, like, 2, 3 in the morning. We're like, Big T, you gotta fucking stop, dude. And he just kept knocking back these full-grown sandwiches. Does anyone remember that shit?
No. Do you remember when he was at a bar or something for some reason, and then he was streaming in the car, like, on the way home, and I don't know, there's something about that. Like,
he was drunk. He went to Buffalo Wild Wings, and they were driving him. He's like, turn off the radio! I'm streaming! And
yeah.
He was a fucking mad. He was a savage. Dude, Big T was a savage. We're talking about him like he's dead, Montrese. He might as well be with what they did. When you and Strawberry were reading them smut for God damn, we've had some good times over the years. 2 hour mark, ladies and gentlemen. You bad motherfuckers. Put it right there. PayPal.me/BigT93.
Fuck, man. I'll never forget the first time I came over here, my first day. First person I saw was Big T in the bathtub. Hilarious. That's amazing.
What an introduction to the stream, huh? What the fuck was that?
Okay, you getting high?
Get high, get high, get high.
I feel like I was inside the fucking mechanism while she was blowing. That was crazy. You didn't laugh. She's fucking laughing. Yeah, I think he took a shit in that water. No doubt. I wish I could grow a beard like Joey and George. You can, Dirk. Come over here. I'll teach you. My pack upset, calling it fake weed. There was a girl who peed on stream once on her birthday, Joey. Remembers very well, I'm sure.
Mm.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, the whale thing.
Yeah. And shout outs to Chris the Canadian with the period suit. That shit was crazy.
Ashcon just fucking playing around. I wish I could grow one of the best beards in the game. Chris the Canadian is future Big T.
Yeah.
That was a lot of fun. Yeah. I hope Big T's toe is okay, Toey. First of all, fuck you. Second of all, Big T has no toenails.
Ugh.
By the way, last I spoke with him, he was getting his fucking got like
are you, like not taking care of his feet.
I don't know. I think it's like a hygiene. It's got to be some poor hygiene cause.
Yeah, because he should be taking care of him.
Yeah. Can we call him High C? We can call him whatever you want. I love it. That's a good question, Spence. Somebody that's been around for a long
time. Yeah, because it's someone who's been around, so why use a burner when...
Right.
He's not even saying any fucked up shit. He's just...
Right! Come celebrate with us, you fucking degenerate. He lost him to fungus. Maybe.
Oh, bro.
Maybe.
Like, what if they don't regularly wash his socks? Or, like, make him take a bath more than once every 2 weeks.
Right.
It's scary to think about.
I bet the mafia would do a better job of taking care of Big T if
we were. Of course, we all love him.
Yeah, we loved him like a brother. It's like we got to visit him. Like, what was that movie, Kay? With was from the '90s or the '80s? Rain Man, where he visits.
Yeah.
He takes him on a trip.
Yeah, and he was in one of those homes, Big T.
He was in one of those homes. We're living the cannoli mafia Rain Mans.
My That's babies crazy. Are living with me. I'm not.
Good for you, Kishy K. We should call it Big T Man. That's fucking insane. I never. Yeah, they were ingrown, right? Yeah, they were all fucked up. It's like his feet just didn't know what they were supposed to do, so they just started fucking around doing whatever they wanted. Kay, how about diaper fetishes? Says Dirk Diggler.
Not me.
Big Rain. A crazy comment. What's eating Big T's grape?
Hey, do you know who's into diaper fetishes? Miami Cuddles, because when he puts him in a diaper, it makes him look like a kid.
Oh, fuck. Jesus. They're letting them constantly eat bagels with ketchup and drink jugs of apple juice. Yeah. Yeah, Big T had the greatest mouth in the mafia. It reminded me of that alligator game when you're kids where you press the tooth down and it chomps you if you don't fucking move it back. But you stick your finger in his mouth. I don't know what you would feel. I don't even know if your finger would come back. It'd be like a fucking meat grinder. I don't know. Montrese or Dirk Diggler's using your line. I don't do that gay shit. There you go. We visited my hot dog casserole.
So the apple juice thing, it's like an autism tick thing. Like, they have a favorite drink, and then they constantly have to have that drink. So, like...
It's just the most unhealthy drink you could
get. Yeah, like, one of my kids is obsessed with orange juice. Like, he has to have it every day. I have to make sure to go to the store that it never runs out, you know?
Oh, shit. Have you ever ran out of the juice?
Oh, yeah. I mean, it's not fun.
I'm sorry to hear that. Big T's sister, what's going on there? Well, she's a little special, I think, as well. It's the high fructose; it's addicting. Both of them. Big T's custodians told them to stop streaming, so they. Oh my God, Marcus!
And yo, Dirt Diggler, stop it! Stop Ooh. It!
Oh,
stop it! I read that comment. Cut that shit out, yo.
You see how I almost read that out loud? I had to stop myself.
I had to bring a Big T, classic Big T picture.
Oh my God. Gangster T. That's crazy. Big T is a Crip, Montrese. Look at that.
Hey, Big T is cool with me.
Right.
That's my right hand guy, man. No, Big T was always cool with him. Yeah, no beef, man. That's Big T, man.
Right. Yeah, you could tell he kind of looks like a GTA DLC character, like a Strangers and Freaks mission. I love when Marcus says, I did some investigating. Marcus, you were wild last night for the fucking Dan comments. I couldn't even, that stayed with me after I ended the stream. It was still in the back of my head.
Wait, what did he say?
I can't even repeat it. It was fucking.
Can you put it in a private chat?
I'll say it. Fuck it. Listen, he's. It's so fucked up. So they asked, I was talking about like the two people I missed the most that passed away in Freightcom, and I said Ash 4245, an OG reviewer. He was autistic as well, okay. Really, really nice guy. Really entertaining, very smart, knowledgeable about almost anything and everything. However, then I said Dan Mish, who was OG reviewer, my Mickers. He killed himself. Rest in peace. He took his life. And Marcus comments yesterday, he says the craziest shit I ever, like Marcus says some degenerate shit, but this was on such a level that I was at a loss. Marcus, you want to comment what you did last night so I can highlight it? I don't think I can say it.
I remember now. Because when you said Dan, I was assuming the other Dan, but now I know.
Right.
I remember that guy. I remember that guy. Well, only because he passed away. I didn't really watch him before that.
Yeah, he was like an OG reviewer from the golden era. And Mark, too lazy to change name over. I'm running PG stats, not R today.
You don't have to change your name. Just say who you are.
He did. He did take his life, sadly. I remember I was following his wife on Facebook, and she went live sometime after, and she was crying and just because she was kind of, you know, she was part of his channel and people knew her, and she was kind of updating everyone that was friends with him online. And at one point you hear her say that he took his own, that he killed himself is what she said. And I was like, what the fuck?
Oh, like, we're talking about My Mickers.
My Mickers.
I was thinking about, there was another guy who did the same thing.
He had some health ailments earlier on. I remember that.
I can't remember the other guy's name, but he did the same thing.
All right, here's the comment. This is fucking insane. Yeah, it is sad, John. Marcus goes, I just stated that I had serious doubts that his old lady whacked him. What do you put her hands on that Mickers? And then he started going off of how he's been doing investigating. And he knows that she did.
Well, it's sometimes so... Marcus will tell us he's drunken, and sometimes... Oh, here we go again.
It's fucking crazy. It was so... It's so bad that I'm laughing, not because it's funny, but because it makes me uncomfortable.
See, that's the thing about Marcus. He doesn't need a burner to say all this, you know, these things.
So. Right. This is why we respect Marcus. I usually use a burner. But... This is what he said yesterday. She had that she had that nasty look in her eyes. Poor woman is completely devastated and heartbroken and in shock. Marcus is
attacking a grieving woman.
The internet's a wild place, man.
Well, at least we know if you've got Marcus on your side, if someone fucks you over, he's not gonna play around.
Right. Big rips to the Mick. I got experience with the new Ralph Lauren Safari. I have two bottles. They're good. They
new one.
Yeah, like the new release, because they discontinued it for some time and brought it back. I used to always smell it at Sephora years back, but
yeah, because my manager, I walked into the, I just walked to where he was leaving at the time, and I could smell this fragrance, and it smelled amazing. And I started sniffing in the air to basically say, what is that? And he went, oh, it's my bag. I was like, it's your bag? He's like, oh, yeah. He's like, a bottle of cologne leaked in my bag, and now it smells really strong. And I was like, what the fuck is that? He's like, oh, it's Ralph Lauren Safari. I was like, oh.
Yeah, it came out in, I think, 92. It's, and I know a lot of guys like the vintage fragrances, but like, it's crazy because it's starting to smell dated, but it's such a good classic fragrance. It's beautiful.
It's weird because I think up close I have smelled it before, and it was like really leathery and dated.
It's
but dated. When I smelled it in the air,
it
smelled super good. Yeah,
I really
more like late 90s vibes, like Gucci Envy or something like that.
Well, that's what's crazy is it smells like it came out in the early 80s, not the early 90s. Yeah. And then now being in fucking 2024, like they're gonna say you smell like an old man. I don't fucking care. I like Safari. I bought two bottles when I knew they brought it back because I just felt like they tried to make it a little more modern. And I loved it.
I think they probably did then because I don't really get like an old school vibe. Well, kind of, but not really. I don't know. But the thing is, they're selling it so cheap now for like, what, $24? Something like that. So it's probably different to how it was.
Listen, man. I would say it's the prettiest Ralph Lauren bottle.
Yeah. My manager even said that. He was like, oh, he's got a really cool bottle. I was like, yeah.
Dude, the bottle is probably the best part. Not even fucking around. The cap, the design, the of course, the glass itself with that cool insignia, right? It's like an insignia.
What do you think of Gucci Envy?
I loved it.
Oh, I've still got a little bit left. Like
I had a sample from when I was a kid. Yeah. Sent me.
I bought a because they had like official samples, like 5 milliliter ones, and I had a couple of them that I found on eBay. But then I found, and this is so stupid, I did this. I bought a partial that had no lid, but I wanted it so bad.
You didn't care. Right.
I just got it, and it was.
I did that with a 2000 and. I think it was a 2005 Abercrombie Fierce. It didn't have a lid on it, didn't have a cap, but the top notes weren't even spoiled yet. It's sitting in my shelf, proudly displayed. It's only I think it's only a 1 ounce, but it's to me, it's fucking liquid gold. It's the best.
Is that the one? Because you wore one of the old versions to the prom, didn't you?
I did. I brought the 2012, which was the last of the good formulations of Abercrombie Fierce. The best. Of course, being the red lettering, but that's most of it's dank now. But they had these metal caps with a different set of abs on there.
And that was you can tell by the picture on it, right? Yeah, yeah.
That's the one I grew up wearing, and that was my magic fucking juice.
So annoying, man, because it's like so
now it's just water.
Dior's the worst because they reformulate so much, like the Dior Homme Sport 2008 and the Dior Homme Intense 2007. Right. Fucking amazing, and they just keep reformulating it to the point where now they're not even recognized.
But they're not even just. I felt like after 2012 Sport, there was no point.
Well, I think the Iris ruined Sport because they were forcing the Iris in just because it's right. Dior Homme.
Dior Homme Sport smelled more like Dior Homme. And it made sense in 2012 because you would think, okay, it's a sporty iris where the ginger 08, which is probably in my top five.
It's fucking amazing, man. Fucking citrus ginger combination. Man.
The citrus ginger zap. I wore that when my sister got married. Mm. And I've had a bottle since 2014. And I've maybe worn it 8 times.
Do you know the closest I've got to that is it's not close, but it's the closest I've got. It's called Zara Orange Zest, and it's like a very, very watered down version of the 2008. Like if you go on Fred Granica, everyone says
that
like 50 people say it's the 2008, but it's like proper watered down.
What's crazy going back to Abercrombie is all of the fierce dupes like Ed Hardy Skulls and Roses or Montblanc Legend, Nautica Aqua Rush. There's all of these Abercrombie and Fitch.
Parfums de Marly?
Yeah. Oh my God. Percival, is it?
Yeah. What do you think of that then? Do you think?
I think Joe Anthony sent me. I really liked it, but it's like, why am I going to wear a $300 bottle of Fierce?
Yeah, I know.
The actual thing. It's a beautiful fragrance, but it's just not necessary. So I own a 1 ounce with no cap that's probably 80% full, which is 2005. I own a 2012, which is probably 70, 60, 70% full that I've had since probably 2010. It wasn't 2012. It was 2010. It's good, John. I know you love Fierce, so I think you'd like it.
Jonathan likes Fierce.
Yeah, he does.
Oh, okay.
One day, Abercrombie and Fitch was like, we're getting rid of vintage Fierce. And I said, excuse me, bitch? The fuck did you just say to me? So I bought 3 bottles of it. With minis, and I wore all the minis, and I bought 300 mls, and I remember spraying it, and it was just like an empty shell of its former self. It broke my fucking heart. It still smelled like Abercrombie Fierce, but if it was faded, if you were wearing it after, let's say, 10 hours.
What about the Mont Blanc? Because you don't have to pay an arm and a leg for that.
Listen, it smells closer to Fierce than the current formulation. I'll tell you, in my opinion, Ed Hardy, Skulls and Roses, one of my favorite bottles. It's a black, like 3D printed skull. It's really fucking cool. You know, like those vodka skull bottles they were selling. Or was it skull tequila? I can't remember. Anyways, I own two bottles of it. You can get it for like $20 now if you go to like a fucking Marshall's or something. But that smells more like Abercrombie and Fitch Fierce than Abercrombie and Fitch Fierce. So I always wear it. But on special occasions when I'm fucking shaking my dick, like the prom, I bust out that good shit. It's not terrible, John, but it's definite. It lost that punch. For it to be an eau de cologne, for it to be a cologne, let me tell you something. It's always been a quote-unquote cologne, but it smelled like a fucking extract parfum, just something crazy. Now, it smells like a cologne.
Well, that's the thing. When you wear a certain formulation enough, you can tell the difference, whereas, like, a lot of people can't, but it's like, if you, like, I got through two bottles of the Dior Homme Intense 2007, and everyone's hyping the 2011. But when I got it, it's still good. But it was, it's, the powderiness was gone, the vanilla wasn't as strong. And when you smell them side by side, okay, there's not a massive difference. But when you actually wear it, you can tell there's a difference. And that's what I hate about it, because it's annoying, because it's like, yes, they aren't that different, but there's a difference and you can't get past the difference.
The store smell. Yo, is that Montrese's dick? The store.
What? Yeah, there it is.
Neuro Intense. So Fierce Intense was on like discounters and I missed that hype train and everyone bought it. Someone was nice enough to send me an empty bottle that probably had like four sprays left so I could at least experience it. It was good, but it wasn't Fierce.
That's the thing about Fierce, is it had so many flankers, but none of them actually took off.
Right. Now there's my favorite Abercrombie fragrances is Fierce. Woods is phenomenal. The OG is beautiful. Lone 41. I don't know if anyone remembers that.
Mm-hmm. I got some old bottles, man. I spray them here and there because I know your pain, bro. I know they just is. You might as well say it's water in the bottle now. So I know what you mean, man.
He said the bottles that fell off the truck. What are you talking, Spence? Come on, fuck yeah. Yeah, the spices is really hard to find. I don't know how familiar I am with that, John, but I know they used to have like an older. Oh, I love Aspen. I always said Aspen was better than Cool Water. I'll die on that hill. Abercrombie, Woods, and Fierce are the only two that you really need to worry about. Like, those are the two bangers. Listen, Abercrombie was like a fucking uppercut, okay? You put on two or three sprays, it's like a fucking bomb went off. You know what I mean? And you'd walk by, and that fucking scent bubble was assaulting motherfuckers, grabbing their ass in front of their fucking husbands kind of shit. It was crazy. And I just, like fucking he said, the smell of Abercrombie Fierce is etched into any 80s, 90s fucking babies. Because
I was going to say that. Like, I think I missed that. I missed that. So I wasn't growing up. They didn't. And plus, Abercrombie's a very Americanish kind of brand. Like, UK doesn't. So I kind of missed it. But
like, if you could describe me, Lou, it's Aqua di Gio and Abercrombie Fierce.
Do you think that's changed, Aqua di Gio? Do you think that's changed?
Because I haven't smelled a new bottle because I have such an old 200 ml that I wear it a couple times a year. I wouldn't even know. I'll tell you what, though. I fucking adore Profumo. It was the grown and sexy Abercrombie, Aqua di Gio.
Do you know they've brought out it's an Aqua di Gio Eau de Parfum? But it apparently just smells like the Profumo. So I don't
well, if
it's not that they've changed the Profumo's name, they have bought out a new fragrance that's slightly different, but it's pretty much the same. So it's like,
and I love it, man. I
yeah, but that's a good one. Yeah.
If I could have a signature scent, as much as Aqua Geo will always be my baby, always be my baby. Do 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 do. God damn it, Montrese. It would have to be Abercrombie Fierce if I had to pick one cologne to wear for the rest of my life.
Yeah. What always stuck with me is when Sebastian said that, because he used to wear Aqua Di Gio in the 90s, and he said Profumo is what he remembers the original being when he
That's
used to
crazy,
wear.
Really?
Yeah, he said it was that powerful back in the day. Whereas now everyone talks about how like light it is, but for me, I've had loads of bottles of it, and it's not that light to me, but...
The original
would have been beast mode, I'm guessing.
Right. There's something magical about Aqua Di Gio because you just know it's the epitome of a man. Man's fragrance. Women, it was catnip. It really was. It was
Do you know what I always got from that one? Is the aquatic notes make the citrus sparkle. Like it has like this tingly feeling in
Correct.
Your nose.
Correct. Like, kind of like when you feel mist on your body.
Yeah, like when the opening of Aqua Di Gio, like you get the citrus notes, but then the aquatic notes like fucking make it, I don't know, man. It's crazy what it does to the citrus notes. Like it makes them fucking sparkle or some shit.
It's beautiful. Yeah. Just timeless. Yeah. Fucking timeless sense, you know. You take your Sauvage, shove it up your fucking ass, you know. Like I like Sauvage, I do. I think it smells good, but for it to be as popular,
I don't like it. You know what it is? It's the Ambroxan makes me feel nauseous. I can't do it.
It's overwhelming. It's a lot. Montrese, what are you doing? I spy over here. Come on, what are you looking for? Looking to see if Sage's floor is clean.
We're supposed to be looking at the reflection.
Right. Honestly, I see his phone. But yeah, I don't know. It's
they all get killed off. They all get killed off. Everything good gets killed off. I just recently found this out. They discontinued Paco Rabanne XS Night. I didn't even know. But I'm glad I got two bottles of it. Everything gets killed off. Even if they decide to ever bring back Paco Rabanne Privé, and they'll water that shit down. So I don't even want it to come back. I don't need it to come back. They're gonna fuck it up.
That's a good point. Yeah.
Sauvage is our generation's Aqua Di Gio, which is crazy. That came out in '95. The blue takeover. Like I always said, Blue de Chanel is. Well, bluh, de Chanel. Blue de Chanel. Gidon's Dijon Bloch. A la hoo.
Is it Robes 08 in here?
Come on. It's 08. Every night it's 08 in this bitch. I fucking, yeah. Let me tell you something. Fucking,
yeah, I don't really buy Blue de Chanel.
I love it. More. It's the
I love it, but I buy this instead now. I don't need it.
I don't even know what I'm looking at right now. Montreal. I thought that said Harambe. Harambe?
Harambe?
There you go.
I got no time.
Listen. Joey, I got through a 50 mil and a 100 mil of the Bleu de Chanel Eau de Parfum. It was a signature for quite a while.
No shit.
I understand. I understand.
It was good.
I understand. I just stopped buying it after that came out.
Yeah, that's crazy. Don't do what I do and save everything. Yeah, man. Appreciate it while you're alive. And most importantly, Ashkan, appreciate it while it's still fresh.
Wait. What? Paul Al Haramain Amber Oud Blue. Is that what it's called?
Blue Edition, man. Yeah.
Oh, with the name, I was a bit thrown off. I didn't know it was...
We're fucking talking fragrances on a Toxic Tuesday. This is crazy. What are we doing, huh? You know what? I was showing my...
We love fragrance. We can't help ourselves.
We can't help it. We're fucking fragrance degenerates. Polo Blue still smells like it did in 2002.
You've been on that recently because you had that the other day too.
I picked this up because I have a vintage bottle. They changed it. This is the modern Ralph Lauren bottle shape now. Ever since Ralph's Club, they went this fucking route. I liked the big, fat, bulky bottles that Polo had.
Yeah, because they were shorter, right? Or they're wider.
They were stubby, if you will.
Yeah, like a chode.
Like a fucking chode, out of respect. Yeah. Kind of chode-esque. But these new ones, it still smells like Polo Blue. So when I seen it at the rack, I was like, I'm the daddy. You fuck. And I like this little motherfucking bear right here. This little son of a bitch got, look, he's slinging bear dick. He's a fucking, look at him. He's got his collar popped. He's fucking around. He's eating pussy.
He's a player. Yeah.
Right. He's eating fucking Winnie the Pooh's sister's ass. You know, it's crazy shit what this fucking guy's up to these days. Anyways, I like it. I don't know. I'm putting some on right now. Fuck it.
Polo Blue's only been out since 2003 and it's already changed.
Was it 2003? I thought it was 02. Fuck me.
I don't know. I could be wrong.
Nah, it's probably 03. I thought that bottle was fake. No, this is real. This is a 4.2 ounce. It is. It's a cool icon.
But that was one of the ones when I first got into fragrance and I smelled it in the store.
Because
I was so used to all blue fragrances being like super
aquatic.
And then I smelled that and it completely threw me off. I was like, what's this?
Dude, it's so weird that when you hear blue nowadays, you think Ambroxan. I grew up in a time where blue meant aquatic. Ocean, aromatic, ozonic, salty, fucking, you know what I mean?
And that's like, unique as well, because it's got like, what is it, melon and suede?
It's got melon and cucumber and weird shit.
Yeah, it's different. When I first smelled that, it really took me by surprise.
It's a nostalgic smell. I look back fondly when I smell the Polo Blue. My dad liked this.
Polo Blue is great. I'm glad they dropped the EDP and, you know, all these other
brands. I love the parfum. The parfum is if it came out today.
You know what sucked, though? All the modern was like Ultra Blue and...
Yeah, get the fuck out of here. Listen, the parfum was good. Nah. The Polo Blue line, I think, is probably the best in the line. I do like red. I love the Eau de Parfum. The Polo Red Intense is my favorite, and then Eau de Parfum. Eau de Parfum.
The new parfum is completely different though, because it's not a parfum concentration. Apparently, it smells like that Paco Rabanne, the one that's like orange popsicles or whatever.
Correct.
I was tempted to buy that one.
Now you should check it out. Yeah, the Polo Red, the EDP. I was like, smells like original, just sweeter, but the gold blend is my favorite out of the Polo Blues, man. Gold blend is amazing, bro.
Gold blend. I don't know if
amazing. Amazing.
I never had the Polo Blue Sport, but they had the Polo Red, White, and Blue. You guys remember that shit? It was like a white, all white bottle with the flag.
Do you know what? I know there was something that you weren't impressed with, Joey. It was the it was the Polo Fresh.
Correct. So let's unbox this real quick. So Polo Sport is the greatest of the Polo line. I'll fight anyone that disagrees with me. Polo Sport is timeless. It was a 90s staple. If you were in high school during that fucking time, you smelled it. Your older siblings wore it. Your uncles fucking had it. Your mother was probably, you know what? Anyways, listen. In the 90s, the Polo Sport was just a fucking monster. I own probably 4 bottles of Polo Sport. They did reformulate it a bit, but it still smells like the 90s. That even is a little dated. But when Polo Fresh came out, Lou, what an abomination of ass. What they aborted that? They should have got a coat hanger and just got it over with, bro. It's fucking crazy.
Yeah, I don't like it, man. I smell it.
I want to be in a bad mood, Montrese. I smell it.
It's not good.
I smelled that. I smelled that at Macy's like twice. years ago, and I didn't like it. I thought it was boring. I'm like, nah, this is, why would they even put this out? Like, whose idea?
How dare you massacre Polo Sport with that fucking awful concoction of fucking cum?
The thing is, people usually massacre fragrances for profit because they want to sell it, but it didn't even, it went straight to discounters anyway, so why massacre?
The fact that it went anywhere. The fact that it was the money was spent on developing this fucking monstrosity, just the worst Polo fragrance ever.
What do you think of that? There was a cologne version of the green Polo.
I have. I'm gonna say something crazy. I love it. I have a 300 ml of it. It's what Polo Green would smell like if it came out today. I smelled it at fucking Sephora. I fell in love because I'm a big Polo Green fan. OG, one of the greatest of all time, Polo Green. And I was like, you know what? This is my, talking about my generation. This was my generation's Polo Green. That's how I kind of look at those things, right? Same with Acqua di Gio Profumo. Same with Polo Blue Parfum is what Polo Blue would have smelled like if it came out today.
Yeah, see, I don't mind that sort of stuff. Yeah, I don't. I like it. I like that sort of stuff, you know.
Yeah, man, I own so much, you know, so many. Oh, my God. It's, I don't know.
Oil everywhere on this fucking carpet. But, man, Polo, I didn't like the Polo Green EDP. I was disappointed with that. I didn't buy it. I smelt it. My dad had it. This is trash.
I think you told me that story, Montrese. I think we had this conversation a while ago.
You know, if Polo Green EDP was a person, I would go to jail, bro.
What? That's crazy. It's good. It's not. I get it. That's good. At least we can agree that the other one sucks.
Hey, there's another thing that I agree with Montrese on, and that is gray flannel. I like it.
It's fucking garbage.
No, you don't,
Jerry. Stinky, pissy, fucking funeral flower in an inner city bathroom. Piss bottles under the fucking table. Fucking
disgusting.
It smells like fuck pie, okay? You know what I like, boys? It's fucking gray flannel. The blue one, the eau de gray flannel. That shit smells fucking good. You ever come to my fucking house wearing gray flannel? God rest your soul. That's fucking crazy. You walk in smelling like a fresh ass shit and you're having dinner at my table. Are you out of your fucking mind?
It smells like someone's mowed the lawn and then left the trim
stuck under the fucking lawnmower.
That's why I love it, because it's like it smells like being outside. When in the elements around nature,
I like it, man. I'm a fan of it. I'm glad you say that, Joey. I will not wear it in your home.
Out of respect, thank you, Montrese. It's fucking crazy. If gray flannel was a fucking person, it'd be Whiskey Reaper. Anyways, with that being said, we're coming in at the end of the fucking stream, ladies and gentlemen. Oh yeah! Listen. Oh, yeah. Did you cook that turkey yet, Joey, or are you still doing bad things? So, if you guys have been following my reels, which I know you motherfuckers haven't because you would have commented. I know Spencer has. I've been slowly releasing the Thanksgiving annual turkey stuffing video. And it's some real degenerate shit. They're getting like 2,000 views. People fucking love them. They're into that shit. But, if you go on Joey Cannoli, my monetized channel, you can see the turkey fucking in. The videos are fun. They're real short. I think you guys will like them. Check it out.
I've always wanted to ask you, there's a video of like a big lady in a chair, and you're like recording her and asking her questions. Who is that lady?
I interviewed a lot of big women in a chair. Old woman?
It was just like the lady's belly. Like, that was like the first.
Dog, listen, I've done some wild shit. Big belly.
You yeah, have a video, yeah. It's like the what the grandma has. Oh, I don't know. I can't.
Yeah, it's somewhere. And it looks like flowers on her belly, like she was cooking and she spilled flour on her belly. And it's all the sexy
grandma video.
That's it.
She's making a pizza with her fucking belly.
It's got like 50k views.
I think it's got more than that. I think it's my most viewed video. Let's take a look real quick. What you're talking about, Montrese, is sexy grandma shows her milkshake. It's got 71,000 views. It's been 12 years since I filmed it. What the fuck?
Oh, damn. 12, man. I was 24 years old. God damn.
Almost got 72,000 views.
People were going next, looking for something else, because that's how old YouTube was. People put like all kinds of stuff.
I was putting up degenerate shit when I was a kid, man.
You know who I really. There it is.
Hold on a second. Let's...
What?
What the fuck?
Dog, I was doing some underground shit back in the day. Listen, this is crazy. This is crazy.
What the fuck?
Is that what gray flannel smells like? Why don't you lean in and tell me, Paul?
Ah. The underboob gotta be smelling like cheese.
Marcus, like, what? How the fuck are you guys subscribed to me and you guys have never seen this video? This is like the one that's in the algorithm.
Yeah, I see that.
A lot of people are going. This is the second person to go after Fat Boy. Juan loves drama, acting like he doesn't on his stream earlier. What a coward.
Oh shit.
It's the second comment tonight. So Ashcon says I can't watch this. I guarantee you he's seen it many moons ago.
Mm-hmm.
Yo, can't say my lord without making me think of somebody. Interesting.
She's looking like, I feel like that's a scene out of Texas Chainsaw Massacre.
Yeah, I could see that.
Yeah.
I will neither confirm or deny that. Listen, different strokes for different folks. Yeah, the great white buffalo was, he said that she. Come on.
She.
My three most viewed videos are 71K, the Volva. I played them last time. Yeah. For
is
some
Ken
reason.
Six I be, is that one? Can six be too aggressive or something?
Correct.
I get a lot of slack for that too, because the gray flannel, I get hella slack. Like, come on,
yeah,
man.
I remember you saying your auntie or told you to go wash it off or something. Yeah.
I like it.
Maybe we'll wrap up this stream with a classic classic best of clip.
Yeah. You know it's a classic.
What do you got?
This is a classic, bro.
Oh yeah, I fucking love Aspen.
Aspen.
You can eat your Aspen, Kay, right?
Yeah. There's barely any in here now. I've fucking ran through this shit like it ain't no tomorrow, bro. See that shit?
Yeah, you put a good dent in there.
Hey, take it easy, Ashcon.
I run through that shit. Every summer, I just go crazy with it.
Good. We got Juan here. Juan, what is going on? What went down on your stream that people are coming in here upset? They say the same stuff they said before. I'm glad for the feedback. What is going on here? What happened? Juan. What did I miss? What
the fuck? Juan tripping.
Juan's really nice. So whoever's being mean, shut the fuck up.
Oh, shit.
That's right. That's right.
Dolce and Gabbana Light Blue Forever.
That's one of my favorite women's fragrances of all time. Light blue for women is pretty much the female Acqua di Gio, in my opinion. That's how
it's like Versace Mano Fresh.
Right, right. It falls into that category.
I actually like the intense for the women better than the one for the men. That shit is good.
Mm-hmm. No, what is it? Light, is it light blue forever or light blue, the grapefruit one?
Forever.
Oh, Italian
love is fucking fantastic. It's pure fucking one. Grapefruit. I have that in my fucking closet. Shout out to the gays. I wore it all last summer. I'm gonna wear it this summer. Sticks going after Fat Boy. This is crazy. Had the grapefruit as well, but the Italian love was just nothing.
When I went to the US last year on my way home, I was just about to go back into the country, and I smelled that just before I went back into England. I smelled it, and it was really good.
Yeah, Forever was Italian love was the shit. But yeah, they discontinued that shit, but it's all good. I got three bottles. It's all good. Yo, this lady was selling that shit. This lady was selling that shit for $40. I brought one bottle. She's like, I'll give you two more for $20. I got to get rid of them. I'm like, good. I'll take them.
Montrese, you're always good. Anytime you say something's discontinued, you've always got the backups, and that's what's up.
When they drop shit, that's fire, bro. You got to snatch them up, man, because they do that shit. They're discontinued.
Women, come on. Schlong is going after Juan, who Juan, from what I can recall, has put Schlong on the dead to me list. Juan is
I Schlong, agree.
Is Schlonghammer going to be on the dead to me list for 2K24?
And then Peter South, you can eat a South African gray elephant's asshole for all that's I fucking care.
Crazy.
Oh yeah, Living Stromboli.
Juan ain't worried about stinks. He ain't worried about none of that shit, man. Juan is cool with me. That stinks, bro. His name ain't Sticks, it stinks. Shout outs to Blondie.
Oh, I remember that stream, man. That was Nick's debut as well. That stream's a classic.
Classic.
Oh man. I went back and watched that like 3 or 4 times.
Yeah. It was a good stream.
Quit protecting your own, Kishi K. Juan would talk shit about you too if you weren't here and were at Smelly still.
Juan and I are friends, so yeah.
He just don't know.
Juan says nothing really, just a planned stream for Fatboy. The stream week you're doing, Fatboy Fragrance.
Don't you love how like Fatboy is not raging in the comments? He's just like,
he's chilling.
Just chilling. 2024. This dude is a straight up dude. Oh my god! And he going after Joey in the past over slot times. AKA, oh my goodness.
Why is it always about the past? It's never about the here and now. It's always if you were doing this or something that happened in the past. It's like,
look at Kitchen in the past. Like, I used to not be friends with Joey. I talked hella shit about Joey. But Joey and I are friends now.
They friends now.
Yeah.
Shit, look. I'll talk shit about Kay. You know what I'm saying? But we friends now.
I talked shit about Montrese forever ago. Yeah. Look at us. We're cool now.
Yeah, this is shit. I love cake.
Oh,
damn. Okay. What's going on? You looking for a friend? Where are you, in a hotel room? Was it Motel 6? What you doing? You got very masculine features, huh? God damn. Turn that shit down. You lay on your head.
Sonic Twisted Texan cheeseburger or a footlong cone.
I know you ain't gonna sit here blaring the fucking TV while you talk. While I'm talking to you, you better turn that shit off right now. You motherfucker! I'm gonna hit the mute button. I'm hitting the mute button. Hold on.
I don't know why I'm laughing at myself.
This motherfucker.
It is so hard to feed you motherfucker. Because the seagulls are attacking them.
You motherfucker. You're going to sit there.
The entire time. You ass.
I will fuck you in the ass. I will come in your room.
He gets me so excited in the fact that
you motherfucker.
Together, it's gonna be great.
You look like you got kicked by a mule. Shut that shit off.
You know, the conversation as soon as Josh and Lance get here, obviously he's gonna turn to protein shakes, pull ups.
I'll shove a protein shake up your fucking ass.
And when in doubt, I'm just gonna fuck it. That's what we're told.
My head's cold.
I'm not saying anything about God, anything like that. Teenage 12, I'm gonna say shells. Obviously, with all the cameras out here.
Oh, yeah, I'm like, what's up? I'm sorry, this.
But, like,
Oh my god, Daddy. Oh my god, fuck me, Daddy. Oh my god, yeah. Oh my god, Daddy, fuck me.
He's for welfare, baby.
You're
gonna hit next, bitch. You're gonna hit next, bitch. We want some pussy. Hey, we want some pussy. We want some pussy. He's been a poor little fuck.
There's a foul. Goes on McKinney.
You ain't no high value man. You're a high ass pussy that keeps pissing his bed.
I think he can mean. If you talk to the Lakers, what do you think the team
we're too invested.
Now it's Portland, the Lakers tomorrow night, which is shaping up to be a big deal to plug in the system even more. You know he will in his 15th season with his fingerprints. To run Lou, of course.
I'm hitting next.
They began the song. It's by Harold. Goodness, I don't know if it was because Cousins was slower. Harold.
All right.
That's crazy.
I feel like we've seen
this person before. Yeah, he. I think that was backstage, Duncan. I don't think we did that live. We had a drunk guy. He was shaving his face, fucking raw with no cream, and he actually took a chunk of flesh out of his face, and it just started pouring down. And we were like, "Bro, fucked up." My man had a piece of his fucking face on the fucking counter. It was the craziest shit ever.
Yo. That's crazy.
I don't know.
Echo.
Is the echo still? Oh, I was going to play another video. Fuck me. There we
go. Ooh, echo.
He said, mm. I think this was a nice chilled. Yo, I used to watch the Faces of Death with the they're eating the monkey brains and the execution video. The only thing in those videos that were real, I think, were the sueys and then the animal cruelty shit. Everything else was staged. It was Traces of Death that had all of the real footage. That was the real fucked up shit. We used to sneak those and watch them when we were kids. Shit was terrifying. Everything you've seen, you thought was real.
No, one of the most fucked up shows was, if you think about it, was actually Scarred. Yeah, you don't remember that? Scarred, the old TV show? Skateboarders getting fucked up?
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Yo, you remember, what was it called? Was it Bum Fights? Yeah, yeah, she bounced, John.
Yeah.
It's real, says famous YouTuber. There you go.
My father-in-law ate monkey brains.
Oh, yeah, the suicide. He pulls out the revolver. He's like, now, now, everyone calm down. I, and then he just, pop! That shit looked like someone turned on the fucking Hawaiian punch faucet. That shit was leaking. Anyways, out of respect. Cannoli Mafia, 3 hours. Coming in fucking hot over here. We had a little clown of the week. Lou, clown of the week, of course. Remind us before we wrap this up.
Whiskey Creeper, Whiskey Weeper, Whiskey whatever you want to...
Most annoying voice in all of Freecom or Whiskeycom?
Montrese.
Whiskey bitch.
There it is. Long live Big T. Indeed. Ladies and gentlemen, tomorrow's the best night of the week. I can't wait to see you there. Be sure to tune in. We may have a No Fear appearance. You'll have to check it out. Kishu K is going to be serving up some sick fucking raps for us. Like always, going to have a great fucking time. Super shout out to the after party stream and super special shout outs to Shishi LaRue. Gave you 4 hours today. I think it's time. Time to wrap up. Time to grow up. Time to move on. Time to let go. Yeah.
Shouts to Mike V. And you may find yourself living in a shotgun shack, and you may find yourself in another part of the world, and you may find yourself behind the wheel of a large automobile. And you may find yourself in a beautiful house with a beautiful wife. And you may ask yourself, well, how did I get here?
Letting the days go by. Let the water hold me down. Letting the days go by. Water flowing underground into the blue again. After the money's gone. Once in a lifetime. Water flowing underground. And you may ask yourself, how do I work this? And you may ask yourself, where is that large automobile?
Good night and good luck, y'all. Shout outs to the ladies. Shout outs to the Mercedes. Shout outs to little dwarf ass babies. Come on, we out.